John McCain, a one-man Hegelian dialectic in motion, playing both sides to successfully roll out 53 annual defense bills and blaze a trail of unchecked ties to ISIS leaders.
Are we completely lost our sense of any moral caring and concern about thousands and thousands of people who are murdered, who are made refugees, who are dying as we speak? And the Secretary of State says that we should not light our hair on fire. Do we give a damn about what's happening in the streets of Ramadi and the thousands of refugees and the people and innocent men, women, and children that are dying and being executed and their bodies burned in the street?
Everyone in the national security team recommended arming ISIS, and the president by himself turned it down. We've determined that Bashar Assad has killed about 100 to 150 people with chemical weapons.
Seymour Hersh says Barack Obama refused to acknowledge the fact that the Al-Qaeda-affiliated Al-Nusra Front was a suspect of the crime.
They want to get Iran. To get Iran, they want to destabilize Syria. That's the whole point. And they're trying to find which method is going to work better. They decide they probably better invade with troops, and then the pretext is going to be Assad's a bad guy who uses chemical weapons. Now, if this cover story is created in 2012, and maybe before, and we're just playing it out today, this is obviously, you know, making the facts fit a lie.
Now McCain has been roped in once again to ISIS. McCain responded on his official Twitter account remarking, "Another nutty conspiracy theory from the Russian internet trolls. I'm very proud to be a target of America's enemies." In a response to a staged ISIS beheading video, which pro-Russian hackers claim was found on one of his staffers' electronic devices. Pro-Moscow hacktivist outfit Cyber Burkitt released the video. Cyber Burkitt previously took credit for hacking NATO websites and obtaining correspondence from within the United States Embassy in Ukraine. The group insisted that the footage was hacked from a device belonging to one of McCain's assistants during a trip to Ukraine last month, but there was no accompanying evidence for this claim. The video, replete with desert scenery, professional lighting, and a director, appears to be the same video doled out to the masses through the propaganda arm of the Pentagon. Look at this video from Turkish media network Kanal D's highly successful TV show Valley of the Wolves. It shows the exact same setup as the recent beheading videos from ISIS. He followed up with a subsequent tweet in which he stated, "First they doctored pictures to say I met with ISIS. Now Russian internet trolls say I staged ISIS executions. Proud to be their number one adversary. But are we supposed to just look the other way, Mr. McCain? When you're a pictured meeting with the likes of Abdul Hakim Belhaj, who is now the leader of ISIS forces in Libya. Belhaj, who implemented the brutality of Sharia law in Libya and worked directly with U.S. and NATO forces during the overthrow of Gaddafi."
And let's be honest here, there's clear evidence in my judgment that the Libya consulate that was attacked on the 9/11 anniversary was very much involved in moving, you know, obtaining surface air missiles and other arms from the Libyans and transferring it via the Turks to the rebels in Syria. I just don't think it's in our interest to be doing that sort of thing based on the fact, as you mentioned, Alex, the chances are pretty good this is all going to come back and bite us someday.
Senator, how do we know that the arms that are going to the Syrian rebels are not going to get into the hands of ISIS?
Because if we had people who could were there to funnel it to the right people, and I know these people, and I know who they are, and I know how to do it, and so do other people.
Do you have any comments about the arms deal from Benghazi getting into the hands of the Syrian rebels?
That didn't happen.
The 15,000 Stinger missiles?
No, didn't happen. It didn't happen. Why would you think such a thing?
Pawns like Senator John McCain would have us believe that 2 + 2 = 5, that the sky isn't blue, as the stench of treason wafts through the halls of Congress.
Well, no. We're going to have a fight because it's patently false. This is the same Rand Paul that said we didn't want to have anything to do with anything to do in the Middle East.
Welcome, my friends. It is Tuesday, the 21st day of July, 2015. I'm your host, Alex Jones. And there's so much important news today that I had cleared the decks of two guests that we already had booked for the broadcast. And we're going to reschedule both Larry Nichols, the Clinton insider, with the latest intel and Tosh Plumlee, the CIA whistleblower, to interviews next week. But then getting into the office, I knew that yesterday Joe Biggs, InfoWars reporter, had gone out to the different armed services recruiting centers in Central Texas to investigate what they were basically doing to protect themselves and to draw attention to the fact that they're not allowed to be armed when they're obviously soft targets and something that Islamic extremists have been targeting for years. There's not just the attack of last week or the Garland situation. There have been other Army, Navy, Air Force, Marine recruiting centers that have been attacked before, but it's kept very quiet and is out of the headlines very quick. Whenever you see a situation like a white supremacist who's on amnesiac drugs going in and killing 9 innocent black people, it's made the biggest news story for a month, used to remove Confederate flags, to try to pass anti-free speech laws, to have Homeland Security get more funding under FEMA, to set up a domestic extremist monitoring network of secret police. But when you have foreigners pouring in who aren't compatible because of their Wahhabist, Saudi Arabia extremist background, we're told that we need to just understand it's not terrorism. And so I've been on the phone with Joe Biggs. Jakari Jackson is out there with him as well. They're going to be on with us at 12:08 or 8 minutes into the next hour at the major Army, Navy, Marine Corps, Air Force recruiting center at South Park Meadows in South Austin. Paul Watson is going to do a quick article on this, and then we're going to have video by the next hour to add to the article. Here is the breaking news. Joe went out there to several different recruiting centers, and the recruiters inside wouldn't talk to him, said, "We've been ordered not to talk to anybody." That was 2 days ago. He went back out there yesterday in his Army uniform with a head down 5.56 M4, and they appreciated the protection and said, "Okay, come on in. We're going to tell you what's going on. We're getting death threats at recruiting centers all over the country, in Las Vegas, in areas of Florida, and we're getting activity we're not even supposed to tell you about the specifics right here in Central Texas in San Marcos. And we've reached out to San Marcos. They say they're not allowed to talk about it." While Biggs was there, a guy in a beat-up Marine Corps uniform was driving around in circles around the recruiting center at South Park Meadows while he was standing guard for 7 hours yesterday. Pulled up, looked at Biggs, rolled down the window, was Arabic, gave Biggs a very suspicious look, and sped off. It appears there are people just where he's at that are casing things, and there are phone calls being made and threats. And they've been told don't talk about it. Again, ISIS was allowed to recruit on Facebook, on YouTube, on Twitter. The Free Syrian Army for 5 years has been recruiting in the United States, the UK, and Europe heavily. They get more fighters from Europe and the United States and from the stands under Russia than they do out of Saudi Arabia and Qatar and other areas. So they've allowed to recruit these groups. They've put them in power. They've changed the name to ISIS. Obama has said the answer isn't bombing them. And what you've got is fellow travelers who are buying into the ideology, lone wolves, bots, operating on their own. The globalists don't want this. They want a Saudi Arabian NATO-backed proxy army that the Pentagon's exposed 2 years ago and told Obama they weren't going to back, so they just switched this new strategy. So to the Pentagon's credit and to the military's credit, they've been not going along with this and dragging their feet and leaking the information. They don't want these attacks because it exposes that the West is supporting these groups and the border's wide open. That's why there can be 5 more attacks, 10 more attacks, 20 more attacks. They are never going to say it's Islamic extremism. They could attack police departments, shopping malls, schools, anything. They're doing this. There were more attacks all over the Middle East, Africa, and Europe this week. Ships getting blown up. Refineries getting blown up. France is getting hit every few days. They're covering most of them up, just saying, oh, this refinery blew up. That refinery blew up. Somebody just shot a cop. We don't know what's going on. The political correctness, so they can bring in the massive numbers of people whose cultures aren't compatible and then play off the clash of civilizations, use the threat as a way to federalize local police, which they'll then double back and use on the patriots, the veterans, the gun owners, which Homeland Security admits is the domestic terror and their main enemy. Now, even the Washington Post had to admit that there are big demonstrations at the Army recruiting centers in Chattanooga, the Marine Corps recruiting centers, and other centers by people that understand what's going on. They invoked Islamophobia to go take out Iraq that hadn't done anything to us and was opposing radical jihad. I'm not lionizing Saddam. The truth is he was a good guy compared to these people. They're trying to take out Assad, a good guy compared to these people. A good guy compared to Saddam, by the way. Of all these people, one of the better people. Some could say actually a good guy. Gaddafi, not a good guy, but starts working with the West for 8 years, gets set up, they bring in al-Qaeda, ruin the country. That was the plan. This is so big, and I got so upset when I learned about this. And I mean, this isn't an act. The crew knows it. I could barely go on air 15 minutes ago. And luckily, we had a John Bound report on this very subject, how John McCain has been caught funding the Free Syrian Army and ISIS, so it fit in together. See, this is a normal response to physically get angry. Physically. Because I projected out in my mind how the story will go. It'll probably be ignored. Nothing will be done about it. There'll be more attacks. It's insane. By the way, call Joe. I know he's filed a report, but we're just going to go to him live next hour. Will you please have him tweet so we can add it to Watson's article? 5 or 6 tweets breaking down what happened, that he's here in Austin, South Park Meadows, was told they're getting threats all over the country. Everything he told me, that they've been told that they're not supposed to talk to the media and that they're really concerned and they know they're sitting ducks. Because we're breaking the fact that we were told by the people, we're not going to say who, but the folks that work there, that yes, they're getting confirmed reports from Nevada, from Florida, and other states that they're getting threats, and they're getting threats in San Marcos, but aren't at liberty to go into details. That's south of Austin. We have the governors calling for arming the recruiting centers. But it's insane, especially in states where it's legal to own guns. Why don't we just have folks that have concealed carry who are off duty be able to then, when they're on duty, have a sidearm? And it's because for the last decade or so, anytime a high-level operative of the globalist, Secretary of State, Defense Department Secretary, you name it, is at a base, they disarm all the troops. Knowing that there's a very low probability, but it could happen, that one of them could shoot somebody. See, that's their attitude. They want everyone disarmed. And all of this is going on in the midst of the vets who are on basically any form of disability. It's not just mental problems, not just diagnosed with PTSD or whatever, which they hand that designation out like it's nothing. That then you're told, sorry, you can't buy guns anymore, and the police are coming by, Mr. Johnson, Mr. Sanchez, Mr. Chow. Whatever your name is, every race, color, and creed, you're being screwed over. You're having your rights taken. And it's been done to the vets, well, even longer than 10 years. Clinton started it. It kind of stopped under Bush, started up at the end of his administration, and then has been in hyperwarp since Obama got in. And they've disarmed over 1 million veterans under Obama. And you'll read the Bloomberg headlines, gun confiscations begin in California. The federally funded task force has a list today. More than 50 people they're going to visit. Most of them veterans that are disabled or have PTSD or who have traumatic brain injuries. So imagine you can hardly talk, but you've still got your IQ. You got blown up in an IED, or you know, maybe your legs are blown off in some of the cases. And they come in and they go, "Hello, Mr. Jones. Hello, Mr. Sanchez. We don't want any trouble, but it's been designated now with your medical records that you're disabled. You can't have your gun." And they said in Bloomberg and in the Associated Press and in all the articles that were out yesterday, they said, "We're modeling this." In fact, you guys pull those out of the stack. Thank you. It was in the LA Times, too. "We're modeling this after the VA, how they decide whether a veteran can have a gun or not." So the gun confiscation has begun by stealth. It's just out in the open. But don't worry. The original El Chapo, Caitlyn Jenner, gets a courage award because he got his hair done and wears a dress. He isn't even the real El Chapo. He didn't even have it removed. I mean, literally they're bringing in jihadis from Saudi Arabia and Kuwait. We're being attacked and we're worried about a guy who's in a dress. That's mind control. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm like a race car that when I press the accelerator down too much, I can throw a rod or blow the engine. I am just completely overwhelmed with news. I don't even know how to cover all this. There's a new video that MSNBC is defending of another Planned Parenthood ghoul talking about how they haggle about the prices for harvesting organs from the babies they kill. And it just makes me so sick to see these people that call themselves the left being so evil and so parasitic. And they even look like villains from movies. And then I see the Republican leadership working with them. And you hear them talking about lowballing on the body parts and how to get the prices down or how to sell them for more. It physically turns your stomach as they run around saying, "We have the moral high ground. We have the moral high ground. We are your God. Do as we say. Your kids belong to us," when they're clearly predators and they know they're predators. I remember with Mike Hansen, he's got two or three of the TV reports, and then we dug through the archives and could never find it. I interviewed Michael Dell. He was there, interviewed all these former Dallas Cowboys. They had a smart growth conference in Austin in like 1997. And I went to it at the Austin Convention Center. They just finished it. And I went in there, and they let me in. And I would go, "You're taking people's property and turning around and selling it for a profit. It's not even for the earth. You're stealing property." And they would go, "Ha ha, get out of LA, idiot. Of course we are." And I walked up to this famous Dallas Cowboy. And I said, "Yes, I was just watching the conference. You admit it's a big business and Bank of America's here." And he goes, "Get out of my way." He just shoved me out of the way as soon as he heard what I was saying. And they would look at me and go, "Of course we are." And it was just so predatory. It's like in a Disney movie or something where you're at the bad guy's hideout and the criminals are standing around with the robbed loot. They're going, "This is really good. Oh, yeah. Put that little one in the dungeon." Yeah. I mean, they act like Skeksis out of The Dark Crystal. When I was growing up around my family that were really nice, loving, good, hardworking people, I thought when I went and saw archetypes in movies of corrupt gangsters or of serial killers or of whatever the case was, that was Hollywood overdoing it. Until I met real New York mafia and they act just like that. I'm not saying they're the ultimate evil. I'm just saying they really act over the top and, you know, the fake crying and all of it. And the, "Oh, I love so much. Oh, you, oh." And then meanwhile, you get around really wicked people. The mafia is like angels compared to them on average. And they are like, "Oh, yes, that's all ours." I mean, you just cannot understand the evil we're dealing with. I mean, I know you do. It's just this new video makes me so angry. I can't stand to even play it because I think I'll start smashing things. I've kind of reached the point where I can't put up with it anymore. We got borders wide open. They're bringing radical Islamists to stand, allowing them to recruit, allowing them to gear up. And when they start having terror attacks, our freedoms will be taken. And they admit the Homeland Security gear up is for the Patriots. And then I think about how they have thousands of pharmacological crops growing open air that grow everything from live AIDS virus to chemicals. Yes, you can program corn to grow basically anything you want. And that stuff's jumping into other crops and spreading, and all these new mystery diseases are spreading, and neurological disorders are spreading. And if you look at the graph, within another 15 years, basically 80% of people will have cancer. 77% of people have neurological disorders. There's just going to be people flopping around having seizures and dying of cancer everywhere. Already you go to a grocery store or a mall and half the kids look like they've been shot with a mutation gun. I mean, I guess it is biblical. I guess it's the mass plagues. And then no one even cares because everything is being lectured by Caitlyn Jenner in a giant publicity stunt for reality TV. I mean, what a fantastic world where world governments here, they put fluoride in the water, GMOs mutating everything, and then we're obsessed with a guy in a dress. I mean, it's freakazoid. It's Twilight Zone. It's like the whole world's on PCP. And if you're sane, they say you're insane. The story's top linked on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. It's on the Facebook page and Twitter at Real Alex Jones. Steve Watson wrote the article. Please get it out to everyone you know. And what's sick is MSNBC is defending it. That'll come back on you. MSNBC shills for Planned Parenthood as second damning video is released. Footage shows official haggling over price of baby body parts, jokes about buying a Lamborghini with the profits. Now, again, the way to shut this down is to have folks open an open market for the body parts, and then it'll drive up prices. And I love the fact that what Sean Davis points out to Twitter, if you wrote a horror script where abortionists haggle over baby body parts prices over wine and Lamborghini talk, nobody would believe it. Yeah, I mean, this woman out of Central Casting just looks like a soulless demon, and they're all like it. And I've gone out and demonstrated for 20 years at abortion clinics, and almost every time, like the devil out of a poof of smoke, weird people in black outfits show up and go, Satan, and just start attacking. And we even have it on video. And when we're not doing it at the Capitol, when there's Christians just praying, trying to ban partial birth, women in flowery colors, old, young, black, white, Hispanic, mainly white and black, mainly white, actually, start going, Satan, blah, blah. I mean, it's interdimensional, it's Satanism, it's real. Something is going on. In every one of these videos, there's wine, caviar, lavish restaurants, I love Lamborghinis, dead babies, And then MSNBC's like, it's so liberal. Oh, yeah, Caitlyn Jenner, oh, we got the moral high ground, God's gonna be a girl. I mean, it's just... It's crazy. These people are demons. They just appear and start crawling out of trash cans. One guy ran and hid in a dumpster. I mean, they're like demons. And when you confront them, they'll actually just basically roll around on the ground like in Christ time, saying, we are legion. You are legion. I'm sick of you. Ugh. It's like wearing the glasses, folks. I'm telling you, it's like They Live. In fact, maybe I should just settle down and play that six-minute piece that McBreen put together from They Live when we had Rowdy Piper on because, you know, I feel like Rowdy Piper, when he's trying to get his buddy to put the glasses on, he won't do it. He goes, put these glasses on or start eating concrete, man. I mean, once you see it, there's no going back. Just take the red pill, people! Do you really want to side with ghoul women? Over 200 bottle red wine, talking about Lamborghinis and from baby part sales. I mean, do you really want that on your conscience? I don't even know if I can do the show at this point. I just... You know why I don't like it when the cops pull me over and give me a ticket? It's not that I'm mad they're giving me a ticket for speeding. I shouldn't be speeding. It's dangerous. It's not good. I get we got to have some law and order. It's that they'll be... Is there a reason you were speeding 10 miles over the speed limit? Like, is there a reason you're not arresting people selling baby parts? Is there a reason everything's so high and mighty whenever... just the hypocrisy of it. Whenever Donald Trump says McCain's no hero, when it's been in mainstream news that he blew up the deck of a ship and got away with it and was a trustee at the Hanoi Hilton and is an and helped cover up the missing MIAs and is a total piece of crap. But so what if Trump said something about veterans that was bad, which he didn't. He actually supports, and I'm not defending Trump overall, but he supports treating people at the VA, not having death list. So see, really supporting troops, you get attacked. Really supporting them, you get attacked, and then the veterans groups can weigh in and the Republican leadership and go, the very Republican leadership going along with putting the troops on don't treat list can go, you don't care about our veterans. You have attacked all veterans. And then the veterans groups, bought and paid for, go, that's right. You have attacked all veterans. No, he attacked John McCain. Same way he said a bunch of these illegals coming in are criminals. He didn't say Mexicans were criminals. He said a bunch of the illegals coming in are fleeing justice and are not good immigrants. Mexico's collapsed. Of course he's telling the truth. That's indisputable. But they change it to Donald Trump doesn't like Mexicans and says they're lazy criminals. Never said that. You go to the actual speech, he said a lot of people from Latin America are hardworking, good Christian people that I'd like to hire. But a lot of them now are criminals, and we need to stop them. So they turn that around. It's the same deal. And then they can have a bunch of ghouls sitting around in every video, drinking expensive wine in fancy restaurants, talking about Lamborghinis. And man, I'm telling you folks, I've been around them. I even have it on video now. They will come over and in a Linda Blair voice go, nobody wants the black people. You're like, whoa, what was that? They're like, ah, that's right, we'll kill you someday. You're like, I remember one time I was down there protesting the Fortune 500 and all the communists were down there. They had a Fortune 500 meeting at the Four Seasons and they came and they said, we're going to kill you someday. And they're not trying to talk like demons, they are. This little red-bearded Papa Smurf-like guy with these other people, and they're just weak, soulless vessels that I guess the lowest common denominator demon jumps into. I guess they jump into pigs, you know, like Christ said. And I guess that's what it's really coming down to. Whatever it is, metaphysical, galactic, energy wavelengths, group consciousness, I don't know. But it's always trendy women lisping, driving brand new Mercedes, drinking 200 bottle red wine, talking and smacking. And you're like, let me try not to chop them up in too big a pieces because we get all the goodies out of And they start like going, and just kind of thrusting around, Like they're Amy Winehouse singing some blues jazz riff. But you're not on stage turning on a bunch of men. You're a sick freak talking about baby parts. It's not like you're in front of your husband in the bedroom. You're talking about dead body parts and they're just wiggling around in their chair. Oh, I can't handle it anymore. I'm about to throw up. I actually just had to throw up in my throat. I want away from these people. I don't like them. They say our kids belong to them. You understand? They're coming. They're coming for us. God, I can't stand them. They're dangerous. Look at this woman if you're watching us on TV. The buyer. If you lowball, I'll act pleasantly surprised, and you'll know it's a lowball. Sitting around like they're horse traders talking about babies. And the women come in. It's not a child. Don't worry, dear. You paid your $300. We keep low prices for you. I'm going to get $400,000 off this. Oh, I'm liberal. Oh, hold on. Let me act liberal. Hi. I've always told you, they put on these NPR voices. Hi. Calm down. Sit and relax. Sit and be calm. I love you. I can't wait. Red wine, Lamborghinis, I'll dominate everybody. And these are the people lecturing everybody. Excuse me. The second sting video has been released showing a Planned Parenthood official haggling over the price of aborted baby tissue and body parts. During the gruesome conversation, Medical Director, Council President, Dr. Mary Gator even jokes that she wishes to buy a Lamborghini with the profits. Yeah, as if you'll ever be able to use it or be happy, you demon. Look at those eyes. She's got those shark eyes. They always do. And Sean Davis says, if you wrote a horror script with abortionists haggle over baby parts prices, one whine over wine and Lamborghini. I can't even read it. I'm so angry. Excuse me. If you wrote a horror script where abortionists haggle over baby parts prices over wine and Lamborghini talk, nobody would believe it. Exactly. Yeah, let's go ahead and play the piece with the folks haggling over the dead baby parts and the Lamborghinis and the red wine and all the rest of it. Here it is.
Hello, I'm Cecile Richards, president of Planned Parenthood Federation of America. I want to be really clear. The allegation that Planned Parenthood profits in any way from tissue donation is not true.
The footage you're about to see was taken from an undercover meeting with top-level Planned Parenthood abortion doctor executive. Some viewers may find this disturbing.
What would you expect for intact tissue? What sort of compensation? What sort of...
Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
It shall be unlawful for any person knowingly to acquire, receive, or otherwise transfer any human fetal tissue for valuable consideration. Hit pause. That's U.S. code. Now, expanding on this before I play more. You just saw the head of Planned Parenthood sit there, obviously lying. I mean, it's been caught. We know it. Notice her spin. We don't sell or we're not profiting from fetal tissue donation. So now it's a donation. Now they go, oh, yeah, we're doing something with your dead baby parts. It's a donation. Thank you for your organ harvesting donation. And, of course, they're not making a profit because they're non-profit. The Lamborghinis and the helicopters and the fancy dinners every day and the lunches haggling over the goods that are melted down into cosmetics and everything else. That's all part of the nonprofit, and then the people are paid by the nonprofit for profit. So it's all legal twisting with Mr. Maddow and others defending it. You know, Rachel Maddow has attacked me now, I'm told. I've only seen it twice, three times, for selling high-quality nutraceuticals at affordable prices that fund our operation. When GNC does it, Whole Foods, that's okay. When we sell high-quality products, we're snake oil salesmen. But when you defend baby part selling, it's trendy and it's liberal. Because you're the moral high ground. You're a woman with a short haircut, like this lady. And if a woman has a short haircut, it means she's smarter than you. She's more moral than you. No matter what she does, she's the boss. Learn it. On February 6, 2015, investigators posing as fetal tissue procurement company met with the president of the Planned Parenthood Medical Directors Council. That's the head of the council, Dr. Mary Gatter. Now let's go to the tape.
We'll be exhibiting at the Medical Directors Council meeting in a couple of weeks. So I don't know if you'll be attending.
I'm now the president of that organization.
Oh.
She's the president. And liberal. And liberal! I'm liberal! I rule! Ah.
So we had just started the conversation, and Susan was explaining they're a startup, that they have been about a year in business. They're a for-profit company that's connecting researchers with people willing to donate tissue. Our volume, thank you for giving it to me, is 800 a year, with 60 in the second trimester. And we just started to talk about how the process worked with Novogenics down in Los Angeles when I was there.
Okay.
To back up a little bit, PPFA, our parent body, is on board with tissue donation, but we have to ask for a waiver to do it, and we have to lay out for them what our program's going to be like. And the mechanics of it was that Heather, Novogenics person, would come to the site, and our staff would sign the patients up and get consent, and then Heather would look at the tissue and take what she required. So
look at the tissue.
We had to do anything. So it was compensation for this, and we had to do anything. So there was compensation for this, and there was a discussion as I was leaving. They had been paying by the case, and there was some discussion about doing it in a different way,
or right, let's hit pause.
How we're used to doing compensation.
This audio probably doesn't translate too well over AM radio. A lot of our stations are AM affiliates. Anybody who wants to, you can go to Infowars.com and see the video. And it's very clear to hear what she says, and there's closed captioning. We're going to go back to more in a moment because I want to put this on record. But notice now, because there's heat on this the last few years with the pro-life group saying it's happening, first they go, it's insane, it's not happening. MSNBC and CNN say so, and we're women with short haircuts. You do what we say. Janet Reno burned down Waco, but she had a short haircut, so it's okay. And then now they're like, you got to get them to sign the forms. And, you know, you get more money, the bigger the baby is. And she goes over, giving the woman $200, $400, $800. Oh, you waited till 7 months. We're going to bring in a special medical team, and you're going to get a couple $1,000, sweetie. What we're not going to tell you is we're going to get hundreds of thousands because we can get full size. And then it's come out at other abortuaries around the country. They keep that baby alive. They don't suck its brains out. They get it out, and then they gut it right there, make sure all those organs are kept in proper perspective so they can be gotten out quickly. Now, people like this doctor who's on there, who's on the council, they like to keep their hands clean. So, you know, she probably doesn't even know all the stuff that's going on. That's how compartmentalized this is, but that's what we know from China and other countries where this goes on. You can go read Snopes. Snopes, last time I checked, it's a woman with a cat. She's a woman with a cat in an apartment, so she says what's real and what's not. China doesn't sell organs. And again, Bill Clinton's not a liar either. But before they do the vivisection on your baby, there's a lot of money involved. Human vivisection has been listed as a form of torture, but hey, if it's for a baby, why not? If a woman with a short haircut says it's okay, you know it is. Because they're our bosses. Let's go back.
Okay, so I'd like, what would you expect for intact tissue? What sort of compensation? What sort of...
Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
Okay. I don't think so. I would like to know.
Here's the haggling.
What would make you happy?
Hey, pause.
What would work for you?
I'm going to skip the network break, but no more today. But I'm getting too upset. I just can't even play ads anymore when this is going on. The reason I'm getting so angry is I'm angry. I can barely be on air right now because I'm watching the video of her with this vampire look. If I was scripting for a female evil vampire in a movie, like a head female vampire, she'd be it. Her lips come back like some type of reptiles or something mechanically away from the teeth, and the tongue comes out when she talks about baby parts. Well, first, why don't you tell me what you used to pay? I mean, she's just sitting there salivating over all the profits and just looks like evil incarnate. Oh, if I gave you my real MO on these people, I know exactly what they're up to. Oh, my God, I just know too much. It's like Gnarls Barkley says, I'm not crazy because I didn't know enough. I know too much. I mean, these people, Joseph Mengele did stuff like this, and he's known as the Angel of Death. And this is the Angel of Death flying free. Hey, can we go out to break in the last minute of this hour with the Angel of Death, please?
Okay. I don't think so. I would like to know what would make you happy. What would work for you?
Well, you know, in negotiations, the person who throws out the figure first is at a loss, right? So
I don't look at it that way. I know. You want to play that game, I get it.
Look at those canines.
No, I want
lowball because I'm used to low things from.
You know what? If you lowball, I'll act pleasantly surprised, and you'll know it's a lowball.
Okay.
What I want to know is what would work
pause.
For you?
Back it up a minute. I want to play all this again. We'll give you all our supplies. See, dead babies dehumanizing us are supplies. You notice in work in the West under UNESCO rules, human labor is called human resources. It's all in your face with these ghouls who are weak, who are evil, but are willing and able to manipulate men and women that have hearts. I mean, I've got a bleeding heart, people. I love innocence. I love people of every human derivation. I love honor. I love strength. I love dignity. And I sit here watching humans torn apart all around me, their minds torn apart, their futures torn apart, victims of political correctness that is a science to destabilize the human community for globalist dismantlement and rendering down into a subhuid slave class. And they have White House-run publications, when I talk about this, put out transcripts and make jokes. This isn't a joke, fool! You're drinking fluoride, you're eating GMO, you're going to die a horribly excruciating death, your children probably are. The time of judgment's coming from your own system. God judges us just letting us be under you. And none of your evil friends are going to come see you when you're dying of cancer in the hospital. I mean, don't you have any common sense? What is superstition? It's God-fearing. People that are heathen don't have a relationship with God or the universe, but they still feel it and feel like they should be worried about what they're up to. And you people have no connection to God, no connection to common sense, no connection to empathy. That's why you talk about empathy all day. They have studies out from the University of Canada at Toronto and the sister university in Ottawa. And the British did a study, too. BBC reported it, that liberals are 6 times more likely to steal and 6 times more likely not to give in charity. But that's a modern liberal. These aren't liberals. These people are ghoul trash that, oh, I can't stand them anymore. Hell, save us from these scum. I can go to an abortion clinic in Denver or New York and announce I'm going to be there, and people in black outfits will just slither up screaming, "We love Satan." Do you understand? We're facing an army of scum. And what's weird is they have chicken necks. They can hardly walk. They're ugly. They're stupid. And they're evil. And they hurt good people. And they rule us. God, oh, because the devil's given them all the power on this earth to just shit all over everyone. God damn it, I can't handle these people anymore. Excuse me to lay all that. See, I told you I probably can't be on air. I just can't look at that witch anymore. The humanity in me wants to smash her. You want to smash little children? You want to sell them? You want to talk about the supplies? Did you delay that, John Harmon? Just play the damn... Just play it!
Sort of.
Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
Can't look at her.
Okay. I don't think so. I would like to know what would make you happy. What would work for you?
Well, you know, in negotiations, the person who throws out the figure first is at a loss, right? So...
You, no, I don't look at it that way. I know. You want to play that game, I get it. But
I want to low ball because I'm used to low things from...
You know what? If you low ball, I'll act pleasantly surprised and you'll know it's a low ball.
Okay.
What I want to know is what would work for you. Don't low ball it.
Okay.
Tell me what you
really... $75 a specimen.
Oh, that's way too low. That's way too low. I want to keep
50,
you happy.
I've been at places that did 50 too. But see, we're not in it for the money. Well, why don't you start by telling me what you used to pay?
$75
a specimen. And we don't want to be in the position of being accused of selling tissue and stuff like that. On the other hand, there are costs associated with the use of our
space. Exactly.
And all that kind of stuff. So what would you think about?
Right. So way higher than that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd like to start at around 100.
Okay.
I'm going to play more later. I'm going to play the haggling from here. It's like 7 minutes left. And then she does talk about how she's going to buy a Ferrari and all the rest of it. I mean, it's pure evil. And I'm sorry I blew up there. It gets to me, though, all this news. I mean, and to see them dismantling everything and to know they're poisoning us on purpose and just to know how wicked they are, because I've been fighting them for 23 years, 20 years on air, And I was naive 20 years ago or 23 years ago. I'd be at events and they'd go, of course we're criminals. We're going to get you and you'll never succeed. John Harmon heard the top professor, one of the heads of the Army War College, Thomas Barnett, during a two-minute part of a break. It was a three-minute break, but I talked to him for like 2 minutes. And I go, listen, you're not going to have world government and dominate the U.S. and you're not going to take our guns. And he's just like, oh, you will fail. Nothing will stop us. I mean, he's heard him. Harmon up there running things and hearing, you know, the guests when I talked to him during break, he's heard it all. He's heard Rothkopf try to get me to work with him at the Kissinger Group. Come on, Alex, I thought you'd be smarter. Thought I could come on and convince you. You're part of the super class now. Go ahead and come in and be part of the winning team. Well, I don't think I need to be on anymore. I've tried talking to you. Same thing. I mean, you know, they just think, oh, I could join you and hang around with a bunch of vampires. The haggling over the dead babies and their giblets. Sounds like they're arguing over chicken gizzards or something. And they sit there, you know, just really getting off on the haggling. It's up on Infowars.com. It's been years since I've talked about compensation, so let me just figure out what others are getting. And if this is the ballpark, then it's fine. If it's still low, then we can bump it up, Gatter says, the head of Planned Parenthood's council, adding that I want a Lamborghini while cackling with laughter. I'll get you and your little dog, too. And just the animal in me. I mean, a raccoon, if you try to kill its babies, I don't care if it's the toughest pit bull, that raccoon is going to jump on its back, hold on to its ears, and start chewing its eyeballs out. I mean, raccoons will drown bloodhounds and coon dogs. They will get on top of them and push them into the water. And they weigh maybe 10% of the dog. A rat, if you're trying to grab it and kill it, will bite you. This is an info war. Will we stand up for our young? Will we stand up for... In history, three things are honored. Children, women, and warriors. And, of course, the witch doctors, the scientists, they're honored as well. But the greatest honored are children, women, and warriors. So they use this innate warrior honor. Because back in the old tribal days, you know, your warriors would go off and fight and die for the tribe. And then they were going to go fight some vicious men that were going to come and conquer and enslave and basically kill the older women, the men, and just take the children away. That's how many cultures worked. And so the warriors were honored because they were going to protect you. And now we just put them on death list and don't give them treatment. It's the very same thing. And it's because more and more our economy is geared by the mega banks not to produce. We could produce so much wealth, the globalists admit this, that it's unlimited. They argue that's bad for the earth, whatever. They could do it in innovative ways. They want a frozen, feudal system where there's very limited resources, and so they can control you with those limited resources and basically buy your daughter for $10 because she's going to starve to death if she doesn't. They don't want you independent. And notice they sell the feminism as about making women independent. All it does is make women alone, working two, three jobs, turn into total sex objects, and the family broke down and their kids belonging to the state. Every metric shows women are devastated, other than professional women who then have the house husband who takes care of the kids, and then she goes and fools around on him. And the man says, I am now miserable taking care of my children and being at home. I know what it is to be a feminist. That was in the New York Magazine. Paul Watson did a piece on it. Are you kidding? It would be wonderful to be home with my children. Wonderful to keep the house clean. Wonderful to do all that stuff. I mean, they're implying that that isn't fulfilling. I love being home at night or on the weekend and taking care of my kids. I love it. It's so much better than what men have historically had to do, going out and putting it on the line. In the factories and in the fields and in the, I mean, my grandmother's, especially my dad's mother, was like in these beautiful sundresses and 50-style dresses, school teacher, working hard, taking care of the house. My grandfather cuts all over him, out there running combines, out there, you know, doing construction on the side, pouring concrete, working on highway crews. And they owned land and were upper middle class, but working from sun up to sundown. And then there was his wife up there on a pedestal. Absolutely empowered, beautiful, and strong. They have inverted that completely. When you take down men, you take down the whole society, and they've done it. They're aborting humanity. They are ghouls. They are enemies. Coming up, we'll break down more of the breaking news on the shocking video where the head of the Planned Parenthood Council talks about wanting a Lamborghini with money from aborted baby parts and organs. Meanwhile, MSNBC is shilling for Planned Parenthood, basically defending it. Chuck Norris has come out and said the Obama, Clinton, Cloward, and Piven legacy is here to bankrupt the country by design and to bring the nation down into a one-world government, absolutely on target. The establishment's moving to derail Trump presidential campaign as they use the traitor McCain once again to manipulate an election. Swedish immigration officer exposes jihadist sympathizer. She decides who can come into the country, and turns out she basically supports ISIS. When she lives in a free country and can do whatever she wants and has her hair all combed and pretty lipstick on, she'd rather have a bag on her head, I guess, and live in a slave dungeon. Of course, she wouldn't. She just gets off on the degeneracy, the aberrance of supporting horrible killers that hate the West. Because the spoiled, rotten pigs that sit in the West living off of it, all they can do is crap all over it all day because they have never lived in the real world. I want to throw up. Sweden's committing suicide like the rest of Europe. Reverend Graham, Billy Graham's son, the head of his coalition, says we're under attack. Stop all immigration of Muslims to the U.S. And that's not a tongue-in-cheek satire piece. He's serious. So this is really escalating quickly. So we have the Swedish immigration officer exposes a jihadist sympathizer. We have the Reverend Graham coming out saying stop immigration of all Muslims to the country until something can be put in place to stop the radicalized ones coming in. I just want to know why Homeland Security says the number one threat in America. I want to know why the number one threat, we're told, is gun owners, returning veterans, conservatives, libertarians, when they're doing nothing on the terrorism Richter scale, doesn't even show up, not even a blip, and Islamic terror is blowing stuff up in France every couple days, shooting up police departments, blowing up Turkish facilities, attacking all over Africa, attacking all over Kuwait, just almost on a daily basis, attacks in Garland, attacks on recruiting centers, and it's not Islamic terror, it's not radical terror. Yes, it is. Now, Joe Biggs, this weekend and yesterday, highly decorated Army veteran, former staff sergeant in his own right, is physically angry around the office, just like I am, about the fact that they're not allowing these recruiting centers to be armed. I mean, Biggs has a whole gun safe right there in his office, right up by the front door. And then so does every other office. And it's not that we're gun nuts. We're free. We're exercising our birthright. And we're not sitting ducks. We're ready. We're ready. And that's why people, I predict, aren't going to be targeting this facility when we're here. Because we fight back. And these colors don't run. We represent the real America. The pro-freedom, pro-family, pro-private property system that made us the greatest country in the world. And everybody wanted to come here. And so Joe Biggs went out there. When he went out there and wasn't in his Army uniform and wasn't armed, the Army recruiters and the other recruiters, weren't going to say exactly who. It's a joint service. All four services are there. It's a large facility. South Park Meadows wouldn't talk to him. He went out there and stood guard for more than 6 hours yesterday in his Army sergeant uniform with his M4. Truly protecting this republic. And I don't want to give away too much so they don't get in trouble, but it's duty to disregard treasonous orders. They called him in, and he's going to recap what they told him. The article is on Infowars.com right now, red-linked. Exclusive military recruiting centers nationwide are receiving threats. Armed forces locations on alert after Chattanooga shooting, and they are disarmed. Florida, Nevada, Texas, everything from death threats to we're going to get you. And believe me, Biggs doesn't hype stuff up that isn't real. He saw something very concerning yesterday. And multiple tours in Iraq, multiple tours in Afghanistan. When he says it was an Arab man in a beat-up uniform that he believes was casing the facility, I talked to him this morning, I believe him. And then, again, in San Marcos, south of Austin, they're getting bizarre calls, threats, people casing them. There is undoubtedly a lot of people who are basically bots or fellow travelers with ISIS that are thinking, because the media is hyping it up as sexy, about hitting recruiting centers. And Obama and the globalists are not going to be able to cover this up. Simply over the top. So joining us is Joe Biggs. Jakari Jackson's also out there investigating, doing a fabulous job. We'll talk to him after the break. But Joe Biggs, tell us where you are and break down for the radio and TV audience exactly what's unfolding.
So as you can see, I'm standing in front of the Armory in South Park Meadows. This is in South Austin, right off of I-35. Now, I decided to come out here yesterday. I was out here doing some reporting with Jakari Jackson, and I saw a gentleman out here, and I was, you know, I thought to myself, I need to be out here as well. There's no way that one person should be sitting out here to do this themselves, and I just felt obligated. So I went home, I grabbed my vest, my gun, my kit, and I came out here and stood guard until about 8:30 at night last night. So I was out here for about 6.5 hours. I got home, I was able to talk to some other people and get some more people organized. So now we have some people at this location, up in Round Rock, down in San Marcos, possibly Midland, San Antonio, throughout the state. And I really want to get a lot of people throughout the country to come out and do this exact same thing, because it's pretty pathetic that our own armed servicemen can't be armed when they're back here. And yet we trust them to go overseas and fight for our country, for these freedoms, but they will return.
Sure, your Skype's breaking up a bit, and we're going to see if it stabilizes in a moment, but I want to make a correction because I was going off what I was told by one of the other reporters, by the news director, that I thought you were in uniform out there. You're just out there in a basic tactical outfit with a black T-shirt on in the Texas heat, so we appreciate you doing that, Joe, and Jakari. Now, I understand why you went out there, because they're not allowed to be armed. You want to draw attention to it, but the threats of the big news, tell us exactly, without giving away too much to get him in trouble, repeat to me what you told myself and do.
So yesterday I was standing out here in front of the center, and one of the higher-ranking individuals in the armed services behind me came up and said that they got intel from higher-ups in that branch that locations in Las Vegas, throughout Florida, and the one in San Marcos had been receiving threats. Now, the one in San Marcos was getting a lot of calls, hang-ups, was very odd. They said that they've never had that happen before. So that's something that's very, very strange. So we now know that there are active threats happening at different locations across the country. There's no telling how many other locations are probably receiving similar threats. Now, just a second ago, before we went live, I saw that a man had called in and said that he had planted a bomb at a Florida National Guard armory. So that is something that's happening right now as well.
Let's update Paul Watson's article that there are now bomb threats coming in. So from what I heard from you, the San Marcos thing is just creepy. The other facilities are actually getting threats. We're coming to get you, things like that. There's a lot of chatter on Twitter and Facebook. Specifically, Joe, what do you make of the fact that the media is still saying this is not Islamic?
I mean, of course it is. I mean, this guy was continuously going overseas to the Middle East. Radicalized at some point. I mean, you even look at his quote in the in his high school yearbook. You know, there's numerous signs that something like this was going to happen, and even the tweet coming by the ISIS accounts predicting that this would happen in throughout the day.
Okay, well, just to show how credible we are, you've been tweeting for a day that there are threats in Florida. I've been covering it since the start of the show. This just broke in the last few minutes. Indeed, bomb threats, men claiming bombs have been planted. Mainstream news, we'll put it on screen, in Florida. So exactly confirming the type of threats that we were told about yesterday. And again, that's out of News 13 out of Orlando. Man says he planted a bomb at National Guard Armory in Florida. So this is escalating, Joe.
Yeah, exactly. And the pathetic thing is, though, is our armed servicemen can't protect themselves here. Now, a lot of governors have signed these bills allowing the National Guard to be able to protect themselves, but they also have private security that stand guard around a gated fence at these facilities. And in a facility like this, you don't have a fence protecting it. You don't have hired security to stand out here. So it takes a group of patriots, like over to my left, men, to come out here, take time away from their job, to come out here and stand guard. So we need people across this country to rally together. That's what we do in America. When something happens, a tragedy, Americans come together. And that's what we do. We fight for each other. We stand up for each other. That's what it's all about. I'm not going to sit around and let these guys have to come in and out of work and be fearful for their lives because of what happened.
Well, it's a treasonous order to say, I mean, I can understand in the barracks or, you know, at certain events, yeah, don't bring your guns, don't bring your firearms. But to say it's soft targets out in the open that no one can be armed. I mean, at least the officers should be armed. I mean, it's been like that in every culture. It's really unprecedented since Bill Clinton took the guns off the bases. I mean, this is a treasonous activity.
Yeah, exactly. And this is something we need to change. This is something we need to bring awareness to. This needs to be changed. Not only do we need the National Guard to be able to protect themselves, but these locations are spread throughout the country in very rural areas, sometimes in the middle of the woods, sometimes in, like right here, this is a strip mall. If something were to happen, this is an opportune spot for someone to do something to get multiple people. So we need to change that law. We need to allow these men and women that sit in here trying to recruit more people to protect our country to have the same ability to protect themselves in combat as they do back here in the homeland.
Sure. And you know, we can look at 9/11 and radical Islamists being protected and understand they're using these attacks to take our liberties. No, the answer is arm the American people so that no matter who's going to try something, the degenerate scumbag in South Carolina or these degenerate scumbags coming in wanting to kill people, they just can't do it. Then we can reform our military and not have it be a tool of the globalist. That's a separate debate from not giving the troops health care and allowing them to be sitting ducks. By the way, the incredible organization that I want to get on as guest that is posing as abortuary baby part organ sellers and has now met with the director of the Planned Parenthood National Council, who's a medical doctor, about wanting to sell them baby parts. MSNBC has defended the second video where the woman drinking wine talks about a Lamborghini she wants to buy with the profits. And they go, okay, we're about to release another one showing other top Planned Parenthood folks talking about getting rid of black people. And you're going to see the defense of capping blacks. Because I've been there, I've researched, I've read Reverend Childress on, who does this full time. When you get with a private white liberal who's involved with Planned Parenthood, they will tell you point blank, come on, man, you really don't want a bunch of black people around. We need to kill these people. That's what I'm telling you, folks. They are demons. They're not liberal. They are hardcore scum. Just look at it for yourself. And they will defend it. They want us to obsess over Confederate generals and dig them up and flags and all this other crud while they want to destroy this country. Ja'Kari Jackson joins us. Then my son's going to be live in studio. He did a great report with Rob Dew and Josh Owens and others on what the number one real environmental threat is. He'll be in studio with me to talk about it and more. Rex Jones coming up. But Ja'Kari Jackson out there sweltering heat in South Austin. Just wanted to get your take on this situation. With them saying it's not Islamic terror. Now the threat's coming in with a reported bomb in Florida hours after we first broke this. What is your take on it, Ja'Kari Jackson?
Ja'Kari Jackson reporting from South Austin in front of the Armed Services recruiting station. Yes, I'm out here with Joe Biggs, Alex. And when we think about all the things that our fighting men and women go through, and then we tell them that when they come back home, they can't carry a firearm, just like you and I both know Master Sergeant C.J. Grisham, U.S. Army retired. He was out walking with his son.
In the country.
And they said, in the country. And they said, officer pulled up and said, why do you have this gun? He's like, there's a bunch of wild game out here. I need to be able to defend myself. And then the guy says, you're rudely displaying, and takes him to jail. And this is the things that we talk about. The people go overseas to fight for these rights, and then we rob them from them when they return to the U.S. soil. Now, a little bit ago, about 30 minutes ago, before we went on camera here, a lady came over with her two sons. She didn't want to talk on camera, but she came over. She said, son, you see these guys out here. This is what the Second Amendment, it's all about. It's about being able to defend yourself and defend others. It's not people running around, you know, shooting guns in the air like they want you to believe. Alex, you and I have both been to countless open carry rallies. I've never seen a single person shot.
No crime, period. And no. Look at the sign behind you, Ja'Kari. It says Armed Forces Recruiting Center. Armed.
Armed, yes. Armed. That's a very good point.
But they're not
armed. Yes, that's exactly right. So this is the things that we want people to know when they talk about the armed services, that you can't even be armed in one of these facilities. And the guys will come up every now and again and say, hey, thank you guys for being out here. You know, they'll thank me. I'm a civilian. But they come out and shake my hand. I say, no, sir. Thank you. And all the talk on the internet saying that InfoWars hates the military and all this stuff, we don't hate the military. We may question some of the orders that they're giving, like, you know, if they're disarming people in Hurricane Katrina, we may hate that order. That doesn't mean that we
hate the
military.
It's the Republic's military. We hate the treasonous orders coming down, preparing them for tyrannical action. We're fighting for the heart and soul of our military, and we're fighting to get them the medical treatment they deserve, not throwing them in the trash while using them to push the establishment agenda.
Exactly right. So we love our truth. We support our truth. We just don't support everything that they're told to do. So with that in mind, we said the least that we can do, you know, of course, Joe Big Sur, he's a combat veteran. That's the least I can do is come here, you know, with my concealed carry. I got my custom-made holster from Head Down Firearms. Thank you to those guys to be out here and be able to protect the troops just a little bit that I can.
That's right. And I'm here with my 357 Magnum, Smith & Wesson, and the reason I have this is in a jam. I don't have to think. I don't have to load it. I don't have to cock it. It's just ready, and I can shoot pretty much center of mass at about 80 yards with this accurately. And it's a 7-shot revolver, and I got my M4 right here that just so happens to be from HDFirearms.com, one of our great sponsors, helping support the broadcast. But that's a completely, you know, different issue. It comes down to the fact that we're aware this is going on. We're sick of having our freedoms taken for imaginary patriot terror when we know the real terror threat in this country is not from domestic sources. And if there is any terror attacks during Jade Helm, expect it to be blamed on the Liberty Movement. We're not just going to sit here and be set up anymore, Jakari.
Yeah, just like you did the video a few years ago. They're saying you're a terrorist if you pay with cash, if you wear blue jeans. If you do all types of benign behavior, then we saw the guy come out the other day saying if you just recently broke up with your girlfriend, you're ripe for a terrorist recruiting station. You know, these are the type of things that they want you to believe, but it's not a mass hysteria of terror out here. It's just people defending their country.
Absolutely. And the globalists have annihilated any basic American culture or human culture. That's why they want to get rid of religion, bitter clingers, and the guns, is because this is one of the few rights of a free person is being armed. And they hate it. They want to take it from us. It's their religion to disarm us. You have found it. The human resistance to the globalist infestation of mentally ill, satanic servants of every form of darkness. We're here promoting common sense and what's made civilization successful and prosperous. We believe in humanity. We believe in having people stand on their own. We believe in human free will and destiny. And we believe and know we have a right as free, sentient creatures to exercise our dreams until we hurt someone else offensively. And when someone else attacks us offensively, we have a right defensively and a duty to defend against it. I am your host, Alex Jones. Rex Jones has been on the microphone a few times in the control room over the years, even going back when he was about 8 years old. He's 12 now. And he is in studio with us to introduce a powerful report, the number one threat to humanity revealed. Now, overall, that is humanity itself. We're going to go to Rex here in a moment, but we'll look specifically at the number one environmental threat to humanity here in just a moment. First off, I didn't plug anything in the first hour. I got so upset by the video of the Planned Parenthood national director of their national council. This is like the vice president of Planned Parenthood saying she wants a Lamborghini off baby parts sales. Truly evil, truly macabre, over the top sick. And I got so upset, I even skipped a break and didn't even plug anything. If you wrote a horror script where abortionists haggle over baby part prices, over wine and Lamborghini talk, nobody would believe it, said Sean Davis. Absolutely. That crystallizes the surrealness of all of this. We don't fund ourselves off taxpayer money, over $100 million a year that Planned Parenthood gets, or baby parts. We sell high-quality water filtration systems that cut out the glyphosates and cut out the fluoride and the rest of it at the lowest prices out there, the best units. We sell four different brands, depending on the prices you go down. They're all excellent. Very affordable. InfoWarsStore.com. Free shipping on all the products at InfoWarsStore.com in the month of July. So you got about 10 days to take advantage of that. It's a win-win. Non-GMO seed section, the widest selection you're going to find anywhere. A whole bunch of different top companies, the very lowest prices we're allowed to sell these for. The Ark Seed, the Survival Seed Vault, all the top best companies out there. Everything from fruit trees down to tomatoes. InfoWarsStore.com and the InfoWars Seed Center. InfoWarsLife.com. We're going to be announcing in the next hour a new product that's finally here, because I personally, every once in a while, didn't used to, but now I do, have trouble sleeping. And we're going to be announcing, I named it Knockout. Similar sleep support products cost up to $50 a bottle. This costs $19.95. It costs, you know, $10 to $20 just for the melatonin. This has the L-theanine, hops, flower extract, lemon balm, valerian root extract, chamomile flower extract, L-tryptophan, melatonin, GAGB, gamma, ambryonic acid, if I pronounced that right. We went to top chemists and I said, I want the most powerful, safe formula instead of having, because I noticed melatonin doesn't work all the time, valerian doesn't work all the time, but if I take them together, if I said, you know, been on coast to coast AM till 3 in the morning and I had to drink 2 cups of coffee to do it, then I can't go to bed till 6 a.m. Suddenly I can go to sleep. Then I got to get up in an hour, and I'm just shot. Well, I'll take valerian. I'll take magnesium powder. I'll take melatonin. But I got to take them all together to do it. Well, guess what? It's just all right here in one pill. It's all right here, ladies and gentlemen, in one pill. And believe me, it is Knockout. We've had this for a few months before the mass production of it happened. And it's got a black label because, let me tell you, in a moon and stars, because it's going to be sleepy time when you take this. You want the ultimate formula for $19.95 and to support this transmission, InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3139. And we did do a very limited run, so I think it'll probably sell out in a week or so. Then it'll be a few months till we get more in, but and then we'll get reviews, and it'll be even more popular because it's the third-party reviews is why our products are so popular. We are going to sell out in the next few days. I've been telling you of X2 Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine, Supermel Vitality did sell out. I'm going to give you a little news flash. The only thing different about Super Female Vitality is it has Frisky Goatweed. It has a different name, Corny Goatweed. It's got a scientific name, and it's more of an aphrodisiac. It has all the same stuff the male stuff has in it, and it does some other things to your body, not just the libido. But it's Super Female, quite frankly, is the formula I like best, even more than Super Male. But group debates that with me. It's different for everybody. And they go, Alex, it's not too good if you say you take Female Vitality on air. Whatever. The point is that I take the Female Vitality. It will sell out the next week, and it will be 2 months back-ordered till we even get that. The new order's in. It's going to sell out. Supermail did sell out, as I told you, InfoWarsLife.com. And that's how we fund our operation, so I want to thank you all. Now, we'll have to skip this network break coming up because I went long here. I just want to thank all of you for your support, for your prayers. We're not perfect here, but we're real, and we don't compromise, and we're teleprompter-free. And I get enraged when I see sicko people sitting around licking their lips, drinking wine, talking about Lamborghinis they're going to buy with dead baby part money. And then the fact that MSNBC makes jokes about it, these are sick, anti-human parasite filth who promise a bunch of disenfranchised idiots a bigger free lunch if they'll just vote for them. I have no doubt that the people running the Democratic Party are worse than Stalin if they get full control. I mean, I mean that when I say it. They are committed servants of pure evil. I mean, we're facing premeditated evil. You go, but that's crazy. Look at history. That's what you get most of the time, because that's who wants control. That's who's willing to do the horrible things to get control. And good people stand down and they take over. In fact, any prosperous nation that's incredibly wealthy and gets decadent tends to fall to this every time. But if you'll spread the word about InfoWars and others fighting, and if you'll support them and support these pro-life groups financially that are getting these undercover videos, I have no connection to them. You should be flooding them with the donations. They're going to be sued. If you will stand financially and morally with us, nothing can stop us. But that's what Thomas Jefferson said. All that evil men and tyrants seek to flourish and triumph is that good men do nothing. Stop doing nothing. Take action. Good men and women everywhere, you have the power, and I salute you and want to thank you for all of your support. Now, joining us in studio is my son, Rex Jones. He's a little bit nervous. He's done a lot, I don't know, 15 or 20 video reports that he conceived, some of them himself 100%, others are 50-50, others are 60-40. But overall, these reports you're seeing are written up with Rex, with a little bit of oversight by myself and Rob Dew and Josh Owens and others, and Jakari Jackson and Darren McBreen and Leanne McAdoo and David Knight have all taken him under their wing. And during the summer, he's here a few days a week when he's not in tennis camp or in other camps, Christian camp. And he's here with us, and he wants to be part of the info war. He likes to read adult history books. He is undoubtedly cut out for this, and I intend for him to eclipse what I've done. He's way greater person than I was at 12. And I'm not building you up, Rex. I want you to know, you're always, thank you, Dad, for letting me be on air. He has a passion for it, not as a narcissist, but as someone who wants to help people and who wants to fight tyranny. He has a sense of justice and in Christ in his heart. I was pretty wicked when I was 12. Rex is just, I love you so much, and I didn't mean to get you up here, sweetheart, and tell people how much I love you, but you're so handsome. You're a good little knight who's going to grow up to, I know, be a great fighter against the enemy. And I just thank God every day that he's given me a son like this and two daughters as well. I love you so much. I'm so proud of you. Tell us about this report that we're about to premiere here on air.
Well, thanks, Dad. The report that we're about to roll out, the number one environmental threat to humanity today, it's gonna be very exciting. I learned a lot when I was rolling out and doing the research for this report, and I really hope you enjoy it. But just to clarify, before we actually play the report, I'm not talking about a supernova or an asteroid hitting the Earth. I'm talking about the biggest threats that humanity has created against humans.
So we're our hope, but we're also our greatest threat. Within that paradox lies the way out of this. And understanding it, and people that hate humanity, people that love to dumb people down, they have no right to be in leadership positions, and historically, they will destroy us. The type of disasters they create with the technology we now have will destroy us, and their evil confidence will be their undoing. The problem is it may be all of our undoing, so we're going to go to this report and come back with some articles where we show pharmacological crops and other things that are just really dangerous. Here is this report.
Hi, I'm Rex Jones, reporting for InfoWars.com. I'm here at the Greenbelt in Austin, where most people here think that pollution, such as littering and runoff, are the two biggest problems in our world today. And if you look around here, that's easy to see. There are things such as empty beer cans, beer bottles, abandoned shirts, abandoned pants, styrofoam cups, all sorts of pollutants. We've picked up a little bit of garbage from our surrounding area, but this is just a small version of the landfills and dirty creeks and rivers that the government likes to paint in our head as an idea of pollution. What they're really trying to cover up is much bigger than a little landfill. In fact, it is starting to consume the whole world. What is it? You're about to find out. We've talked about garbage on the ground. But what about the garbage in our rivers and streams? This garbage is called runoff, and it drifts through our whole planet's water system of rivers, lakes, and oceans to form a giant trash continent in the Pacific Ocean, which I'm going to coin Gargia. Is Gargia the biggest threat to the environment today? I think not. But before we leave the water, let's separate the facts and myths of the Pacific Island garbage patch. First, it's not a giant island of garbage as depicted in this picture here. It's actually made up of very small and microscopic pieces of plastic that covers 5,000 square kilometers in the North Pacific Gyre. The jet stream and southern trade winds create a giant circling region of water. Another myth is that plastic is killing animals. While it's true that plastic is being found in the stomachs of dead birds and fish, it's not yet known if the plastic is the actual cause of death. Also, small water insects, crabs, and barnacles have thrived on the particles and are now found in abundance across the ocean. In addition to being an eyesore and potentially deadly to marine life, runoff is not the biggest problem we face in our environment. Now let's take to the skies and cover a different kind of pollution. Air pollution has been with us since humans first learned how to harness fire. In 1952, pollutants from factories and home fireplaces mixed with air condensation killed at least 4,000 people in London over the course of several days. A few years earlier, in 1948, severe industrial air pollution created a deadly smog that asphyxiated 20 people in Denora, Pennsylvania, and made 7,000 more sick. Acid rain, first discovered in the 1850s, was another problem resulting from coal-powered plants. Regulations and technology have helped clean up most of these problems, so now pollution is not as much of a problem in developed first world nations. In China and other emerging countries, air pollution is a huge problem and it's spread through the jet stream. Mercury, black carbon, dust, and ozone are just a few of the pollutants that are carried by the jet stream over the Pacific Ocean and are being dumped in the United States. Currently, China is building up to 4 dirty coal-burning power plants a month and consumes over 4 times the coal than the United States. Obama led EPA regulations that will shutter most of our coal-burning plants by 2030, so you can look forward to the higher power prices and breathing the dirty air produced by China. Another environmental danger is called CCD, or colony collapse disorder. This happens when a hive of bees is unexplainably wiped out. Nearly all CCD is being caused by either RFID radiation or Monsanto pollen that bees carry to other normal crops. Albert Einstein once said that if the bees were wiped out, all of humanity would vanish within 4 years. Recently, Harvard researchers linked pesticide use, specifically neonicotinoid insecticides, act as nerve poisons and mimic the effects of nicotine as a major cause of colony collapse disorder. Over the last 6 years, American beekeepers have lost 30% of their hives each winter on average. And as companies like Monsanto keep producing neonicotinoid insecticides, future colony collapses are guaranteed. Now let's look at an unseen pollutant. Nuclear radiation. We don't know what the exact full fallout from the nuclear bomb testing and leaks from nuclear power plants are. But the issue was brought to the forefront when the Fukushima power plant reactors melted down after a tsunami hit Japan on March 11th, 2011. Since that time, countless gallons of radioactive cooling water has poured into the Pacific Ocean. Radiation spikes have been found along West Coast beaches, and there are more and more reports about massive sea life die-offs and dead zones being created in the ocean. You can't see the radiation, but the effects and the rise of cancers and birth defects in Japan is a direct result. It's disasters like Fukushima, Chernobyl, and Three Mile Island, or a full-scale nuclear war that could potentially end all life on Earth. But it is not the biggest threat to our environment. Now that we've covered litter, runoff, CCD, particulates coming in through the jet stream, and nuclear radiation coming from places like Fukushima, I'm about to tell you what I consider the biggest threat to humanity is: GMOs. The real danger is not what is seen, but what is unseen. Not only have GMOs been linked to numerous health problems, but the pollen blow-off from Monsanto farms to other normal farms is causing unseen and unprecedented mutation within the normal biosphere. Everything that we've talked about before this, we knew the dangers and we knew how to deal with it. But with GMO crops, the answer still remains a mystery because we don't know what's going to happen within these mutations after 3 or 4 generations have passed. Here's our friend Jeffrey Smith to talk about GMOs and their dangers.
Of all of the toxins that are released into the environment, GMOs are of a special class. You see, with genetic engineering, you have pollution of the gene pool. It's a self-propagating genetic pollution. The genes that we released in this generation already can outlast nuclear waste. They can go on forever. We have no technology to fully clean up this type of pollution. Certainly, we can reduce it dramatically, But until we have some technique to identify GMOs at a distance, we are stuck with GMOs possibly forever. Imagine being hired by a company that says, we have a little problem, we'd like you to organize the recall of our salmon from the ocean. There's a company that wants to introduce genetically modified mosquitoes. Imagine trying to do a recall there. GM pollen has already contaminated the indigenous corn varieties of Mexico, and we have no technology to clean that up. What we've done is irreversible damage, and this is something that is highly irresponsible, unconscionable. And it was done over the objections of scientists, over the objections of science, a collusion between government and industry. There are two main reasons why people genetically modify foods. They either drink poison or produce poison. The poison drinkers are called herbicide tolerant. Most popular variety is Roundup Ready. Let me explain. Monsanto's scientists found bacteria growing in a chemical waste dump near their factory, surviving in the presence of their herbicide called Roundup. So they had the brilliant idea, let's put it in the food supply. So they took the gene from the bacterium that allowed it to survive applications of Roundup and put it into soybean, corn, cotton, canola, etc. So now you can spray the field with Roundup and it kills all of the other plant biodiversity in the field, but not the Roundup Ready soy and Roundup Ready corn. The other variety of genetically modified crops produces a poison. They take a gene from a soil bacterium that produces a natural insecticide and put it into the DNA of the plant. So every single cell of every single plant in millions of acres has its own little spray bottle that can kill an insect by destroying its digestive system. What these changes mean is that the plant might produce more allergens, more toxins, more anti-nutrients, more carcinogens, or even less of these. We don't know. It's a genetic roulette. In fact, the process of approval of these GM crops do not evaluate these type of changes. In Monsanto's own studies, which they conveniently left out of their published paper, which we recovered later, they found that in cooked GM soy, there was as much as 7 times more of a known allergen called trypsin inhibitor, and about a doubling of an anti-nutrient called soy lectin, which blocks the absorption of certain nutrients. In genetically modified corn, a gene which is normally switched off was switched on to produce an allergen, and other proteins were truncated or changed in shape, which can change a harmless protein into a potentially deadly one. In fact, when they looked at that corn variety, they found 43 different proteins that had significantly changed their levels of expression because of the genetic insertion. So these could be caught wreaking havoc with our health or the environment, but no one has evaluated them. Genetically modified foods and crops are one of the most dangerous health and environmental catastrophes we're facing. And yet very few people know about it.
Now you know why we here at InfoWars believe that GMOs are the biggest threat to our planet today. We know the true dangers of a cigarette butt left lying out unattended in a field. But do we really know the dangers of GMOs? And can we trust our government to tell us? I'm Rex Jones, reporting for InfoWars.com.
Well done, my apprentice. Well, Rex Jones is here with us, and he's got some other added points because it's much worse than he was even breaking down there. And I agree with his overall analysis that GMO is the biggest threat because it's already happening. We already know it's caused a bunch of problems, and it's just getting more and more out of control. And the establishment just doesn't care, and they're already putting GMO salmon in the ocean. Obviously, nuclear war is a bigger threat by itself, but it hasn't happened yet. The establishment has shown they're just going forward with this giant mad scientist Island of Dr. Maru disaster. So, Rex, I noticed you did some research in the last few days.
Yes, sir.
And pulled up a whole bunch of news articles illustrating about pharmacological crops, Starlink, what we know is already going on. And this is just what we know, and it's off the chart insane.
Absolutely. Like, take this one article. Protegene officials may face jail slash contamination, could be AIDS vaccine or blood thickener in the crop. Protegene officials may face jail time for they actually contaminated. They've been caught with contaminated crops. They almost went to jail for this a while ago because the crop was found with AIDS vaccine in it. I'm not kidding you. AIDS vaccine.
Live virus. It was growing the virus.
Absolutely.
And they planted it open air. Well, you shouldn't plant it in a in a, I mean, everybody knows seeds get out and pollen blows. You shouldn't plant it inside a greenhouse.
Absolutely. That's one of the biggest, that's one of the biggest threats with GMO is the pollen blow off. There's like, you'd have a Monsanto farm, then you have an organic farm right next to it. Naturally, the way plants reproduce is pollen from one plant is carried by pollinators to another plant.
Or the wind.
That is a pollinator.
Absolutely.
So even, so with that threat, it means that organic crops can be contaminated by Monsanto or other major big pharma regime crop like that very easily. And another, like, studies show that this isn't good. Like a rat. Rats fed a lifetime of GMO corn. 70% of females die early, and they grow corn and they grow tumors. I don't want to look like the dude in Mad Max that has big lumps all over his body and is completely insane. I don't think that that's a very
You're being racist aspect. Against mutations now.
I don't care. I don't want to.
And again, this is Associated Press and Reuters. This is Reuters, this particular one. Protegene officials may face jail for contamination, could be AIDS vaccine. Let me have the other article. I'll give folks the source on that just in case they are doubting us. This is a Mike Adams Natural News article. New GMO study, rats fed lifetime of GM corn grow tumors. 70% of females die early. And then that links through to the grocer.co.uk and through the new shock government study by the government itself.
GMO is even so bad, like Taco Bell, the worst of the worst, the people that scrape grease off the bottom of the...
Well, let's not go into that. Break down the actual report on Starlink corn.
All right, so Starlink corn, a genetically modified food source back a little while ago, they recalled almost... Actually, I think it was all of their corn tortillas that they sold in grocery stores as Taco Bell products, because they were not approved to sell to the public.
That's right. And Starlink corn had been linked to massive health problems in animals. It was a feed corn. Oh, and they had to recall it from being fed to animals. Oh. Yeah, I'm just giving you examples of what's happened in the last decade. You have dozens more of these articles.
And then, like, another example of when big companies like Monsanto, they've made Roundup Ready corn.
And that's the New York Times. Let's get into that.
Yes, New York Times, weed killer long cleared is doubted. So, 30 years ago, an Environmental Protection Agency committee determined that the popular weed killer Roundup might cause cancer.
They knew all along and told you it was safe to drink. Tell you what, stay there. Rex Jones, doing a great job. A little nervous around the dinner table. He's completely fluent, but you're doing a super good job. When we come back, we got 5 more minutes before our next guest joins us on the gun grab. If you're on Social Security and get disability money, they're coming for your guns. We've got a Daily Caller investigative journalist that broke the news. The story's up on Infowars.com. Exclusive military recruiting centers, nationwide perceived threats, armed forces locations on alert after Chattanooga shooting. And now there's a reported bomb scare with a man saying he planted a bomb in a recruiting center in Florida. That's from News 13 Orlando. That's being added to our article on Infowars.com. Rex Jones is here with us. We're getting into weed killer, New York Times. Now they're basically admitting that back when it was approved, scientists thought it would potentially grow tumors.
Yes, sir. And another thing about this is the Roundup Ready corn, if it's basically what they did with that is they added genes so it would be more resistant and even totally tolerate Roundup. But that's not all. If these genes... If the corn can totally tolerate Roundup, that means that they can saturate an entire field with this known to cause cancer insecticide. But does that mean it's going to get into our food stuff? This is the kind of thing that rots out bugs' stomachs.
That's right. The studies on the honeybees.
Absolutely.
Well, it is getting in the food supplies. It bioaccumulates in it.
Yes. Traces of this Roundup, there's not really a surefire way to get rid of 100% of pesticide. Sure, you can get rid of 80%. Sure, you can get rid of 90%. Sure, you can get rid of 95%. But what about that other 5%? This is the kind of thing that's been shown to create problems.
That's right. Now, let's go to some of the other articles you dug up. And this is stuff you went and printed off. I've seen a lot of this, but a lot of it I hadn't even seen before. What's this Harvard report?
Okay, this is actually from Harvard, one of the best colleges in this country. So study strengthens link between neonicotinoids and collapse of honeybee colonies. I don't even know if I pronounced that right. But earlier in the video, I was talking about collapse of honeybees. This stuff ties into GMO crops as well. As neonicotinoids can be put on crops that have been engineered to be more resistant to them, bees will come to these crops, try to pollinate, and then be killed or take this poison back to their hive and cause total collapse.
That's right. But who needs bees? I mean, you know, it's racist if you don't want to kill them all.
Well, Albert Einstein said that if they all died, we'd be gone in 4 years. I guess Albert Einstein's a racist.
That's right. Let's go. Anybody that questions the official system is racist. Don't like death panels? You're racist. Don't turn your guns in? You're racist. Don't want Planned Parenthood to make hundreds of millions off dead babies? You're racist. Let's go through some of the other articles.
Okay. One of my final articles would be about how Monsanto likes to launch damage control over GMO cancer studies. So biotech giant Monsanto has launched a desperate damage control effort in the aftermath of a French study, which found that rats fed on Monsanto genetically engineered corn were far more likely to suffer tumors, organ failure, and death.
And you've just got article after article continuing on out into infinity.
Oh, absolutely. If you actually look at the dangers of GMO crops, if you look up GMO danger online, there are countless studies by well-known colleges, by well-known professors, all sorts of people. And the mainstream media likes to get into the mindset of, oh, I'm sorry, that study was incomplete. Oh, I'm sorry, that study is irrelevant. We have these new studies done by the very people that make the crops that show the exact opposite and that they're good for you. Put two and two together, folks. If you have a shred of gray matter in your brain, connect the dots.
Well, the public has done it, so that's why they don't want us to even know if this stuff's in there and stop labeling. But when you look at the degeneration of the human brain, the body, all of this cocktail of poison is killing us. So we don't have a suicide pact with these corporations who are eugenicists and are doing this on purpose. It's like Bayer knowingly putting HIV in their factor VIII for hemophiliacs to kill them. I think his mic got turned off just now. Turn his mic back on. I'm sorry, go ahead and finish up.
Just the final thing I'd like to say before we go out to break would have to be, do your own thinking, okay? Don't watch the programs on CNN that say, oh, don't listen to them. These studies done by...
He doesn't have a teleprompter, folks. Coming up at the bottom of the hour, it was the Daily Caller that broke the story late last week, and it was in the LA Times on Sunday. They came out and they said, yeah, the VA knows how to take guns from people that have problems. Why, Social Security is going to basically be run by the VA, and they're going to decide which people on Social Security get their guns taken, because if it's found you can't take care of yourself, maybe you're paralyzed from the stomach down, maybe you have PTSD, but it's physical stuff as well, you're going to have your guns taken. No jury, no judge, no law, you're not a felon. This is the 68 Gun Control Act, with Obama just expanding it outside of law. And they're reporting it like it's no big deal. That's coming up at the bottom of the hour. Patrick Howley from the Daily Caller will be joining us to go over all of this. It is simply incredible. In other news, and there is a ton of it, Swedish immigration officer exposes jihadist sympathizer liking ISIS homepages. She says this shows Islamophobia when she said stuff like, great job, or women joining it, wonderful, you're so beautiful. And I guess she likes wearing lipstick and not having to wear a hood over her head. Sweden's reputation as a place where extreme liberalism has run rampant. It means anything anti-Western. It could be aliens coming to say we're killing everyone on Earth. They go, oh, it's liberal, it's anti-human. Was cemented further after it was revealed that top official responsible for the country's immigration policy is a jihadist sympathizer. The country also wants to pay to bring jihadists into Sweden from around the world to rehabilitate them from their PTSD. And then they've had other top officials. She's one of the top people. It's in Paul's article. 2 months ago, he made a video which he documented how Sweden was a case study in what happens to countries where they embrace the mental disorder known as extreme liberalism. Socialist counselors in Sweden want to offer psychological help and taxpayer-funded jobs to help recruiting ISIS jihadists reintegrate into Western society after they got bored of stoning women and throwing gays off buildings in Iraq and Syria. So they want to teach your five-year-old how to be gay, but then it's okay. Oh, but you throw gays off buildings. That's sexy. Ooh, that's liberal. And you smoke a hookah. How different. The story is kind of bizarre, so bizarre that many people thought it was a hoax, but it wasn't a hoax. Prominent voices of Sweden are actually calling on taxpayers to come to the aid of jihad militants who reenter the country. And it just goes on to talk about how one of the heads of the program is a white guy going to join ISIS. Continuing here, and again, this article's coming up, as I just mentioned. ATF works with FBI and VA to get veterans' guns taken away. Patrick Howley's coming up to go over that. Reverend Graham has come out and said, we're under attack, stop all immigration of Muslims to the U.S. It's kind of like ban the rebel flag because some racist used it. That type of police state move will end up being used against everybody. I do think if you come from a radicalized country and you won't disavow it or you have any connection to it, you shouldn't be able to come here. I mean, I agree with that. I think it being too broad will be used to then poo-poo the whole thing. But it shows how concerned the public is getting, because people aren't compatible that, you know, should they say, do you think women should wear hoods over their heads and have their genitals mutilated? And they say, well, yes, of course. Do you think liquor stores should be legal? No. Well, see, okay, well, if you were a citizen, you could hold those views. We call you a kook. But since you're a radical Islamicist, you're not coming here because you're going to get upset. I mean, I didn't used to believe it 5 years ago when I'd hear about Sharia law in England and the United States and now in Detroit and London. I mean, people selling R-rated movies have folks come in and, like, ransack their video stores. I mean, it's just like, and they'll walk up to folks and tell women at night, you need to wear, you know, clothes that are longer. And the left is like, oh, how sexy. Oh, we love it. Oh. Don't ever call radical Islamicist a misogynist. And it's because you're mentally ill and have a death wish. Here's the article. MSNBC shills for Planned Parenthood. A second damning video is released. Footage shows the head of the National Council, a medical doctor of Planned Parenthood, smacking her lips, drinking wine, and talking about a Lamborghini she's going to purchase with the organs, the organ money from the babies. And how the bigger the baby and the older the baby in utero, the higher the payment can be to even get mothers to start gestating, I guess, to deliver them to the termination centers. But it's okay because she's a liberal drinking wine going, oh, she's real skinny with a short haircut going, oh, yeah, society bells to me because I go, oh. I mean, it is just total sickening evil on display. That is all coming up. I told you about this a few years ago in Germany, said it was coming to the U.S. In Seattle, they're doing away with single family homes. They're banning new ones being built. That's Agenda 21, tyranny through zoning. We told you that was coming. We were crazy kooks. We told you they were going to try to restrict families from having children with new taxes. That's now being announced. We told you they'd have tax boxes in the cars to track you by the mile and tax you. That's all now being announced in Washington State, of course. That's one of the new beta testing centers. They've already collapsed California, so they're moving on. This is the program. This is the plan. This is how they take over. They don't want you being alone. They don't want you being able to have privacy. They want you in big, giant, compact, Warren Buffett-owned high-rises where they can gouge the daylights out of you and raise taxes higher and higher on you, and you can't escape. So that's coming up as well. There's lots of propaganda pieces out as they get ready for this big global government announcement for carbon taxes. As world temperatures decline, they're announcing that they're record high levels. The polar bears are all dying. Submarine launches undersea drone in a first for U.S. Navy. You believe that's the first time they've launched undersea drones? I'm a jet pilot from Pluto. New study shows probability of obese people reaching normal weight less than 1%. That's just some of the news we're going to be going over. But first off, we're joined by Anthony Gucciardi, who I drug in here to help me do a plug for our newest product to join the family of InfoWarsLife.com products, and that's Knockout. Now, we did a limited run of this, so there's really no need to even plug it because it'll be sold out in a week. We are sold out of Super Male Vitality. We're about to sell out of Survival Shield Nascent Iodine X-Tube. We have plenty of Prostagard because it sold out so quick last time we ordered a lot of it. It is the highest quality prostate formula out there, and obviously just doesn't help the prostate, but the government actually admits that saw palmetto and other things that are in it are good for the prostate, but it's good for a lot of things. We're going to talk about that with Anthony Gucciardi briefly as well, but first off, Knockout, tell folks how we set about to create this and why it's so exciting. I'm very excited about it. I have trouble sleeping sometimes, especially since I've lost a lot of weight, and my kids wake up sometimes, so then once I wake up, I have trouble going back to sleep. I've told the story where if I'm on Coast to Coast AM till 3, 4 in the morning or other overnight shows that I just can't go to bed at 3 or 4. I end up staying up till 5 or 6. Then my kids get up at 6:30 or 7. I've gotten an hour of sleep, not with Knockout. I can take this because we've had it for about 6 months before we actually got it manufactured. We had the testers. I can take Knockout 30 minutes before I'm done working, and then it starts hitting. And I'm telling you, within an hour of taking it, sometimes 45 minutes, I can't stay awake. Simply amazing. I can take it at 9 o'clock at night if I want to go to bed at 10. And the reason we developed this was because I said, I got to take, sometimes when I take melatonin, it quits working. If I take valerian, it quits working. If I take them together, it has mixed results. I want something that's got everything in it, known to work together without side effects, to knock me out. And let me tell you, it knocks this guy out. And it takes a lot to knock me out. I've told the story. It took him double the curare to put me under 4 months ago when I had surgery. Took him 9 times with conventional opiate-based anesthesias when I was 16. 9 times. They conducted an investigation because of it and blood tested me, thinking I'd been on opiates or something, which I wasn't, to have that tolerance. So this stuff knocks me out. Anthony Gucciardi, tell us about Knockout.
So Knockout's really unique, and I think really it was made for you over anyone else because you have so much trouble sleeping, like you were just telling everyone, and you used to say, hey, I take melatonin, and it works sometimes. And it does work sometimes. But I'm going to break down why it may not be working, and it is good, and we do have it in this formula. We do have a good dose of melatonin. Okay, but melatonin is a hormone. It's made by the pineal gland, and it just tells your body when to wake up, when to sleep. It's, part of your rhythm section in your brain where wake up when the sun comes up, you go to sleep when it goes down. But sometimes when you just kind of put that hormone in there, it doesn't totally work with the body. So that's why we like to take the natural approach. That's why we have L-tryptophan in there, okay? And L-tryptophan,
that's the stuff that's in turkey.
Right. It's in all meats, and you actually get only a very, very small amount of it in meat and fruit. So what happens is, it's the biochemical precursor to serotonin. And serotonin, here's where it's unique, it can naturally be converted by the body into melatonin. So as always with InfoWars Life, we're trying to give the body what it needs to do its own thing. Instead of just attacking it with different ingredients that sometimes do work, we're using things like L-tryptophan. And it's interesting to note that if you look up L-tryptophan, it's so powerful. One of the things that they did was in the 90s, they had this company had imported a bunch of it from Japan and China, and it was contaminated, and that gave L-tryptophan a bad name. And the FDA actually banned it for a period of time, and everyone freaked out about it. This is U.S.-based L-tryptophan, as always U.S.-based. And, of course, we have valerian root extract, which is my personal favorite. If we go back to ancient Greece and ancient Rome, Galen actually said this was his cure for, this was from ancient Greece and ancient Rome, traditionally used. He prescribed it as a remedy for insomnia. Of course, he was a prominent Greek physician. So this has been used for thousands and thousands of years. But most sleep formulas, this is my biggest issue, will just have melatonin. It'll be the same price as Knockout. So this is $19 for the same price as many just plain melatonin supplements. It has lemon balm, GABA, melatonin, L-tryptophan, valerian root extract, and more. So it
and
is
no fillers.
No fillers.
This is the Rolls-Royce, Bentley, Ferrari, Lamborghini at a Pinto price, InfoWarsLife.com. Knockout. Try it out. Review it. Let us know what you think. I want to come back briefly, though, and talk about Prostagard, which we have in plentiful supply. We have Patrick Howley from the Daily Caller joining us. They've been on top of it in the last week, really breaking the news, Drudge linking to it, forcing the mainstream media to cover it over the weekend, that they're going to use systems that are secret from the VA, where they determine whose guns to basically take from veterans. Well, now they're going to use that on Social Security recipients. And we see this model where, oh, you get welfare, we're going to force inoculations on you. Oh, you get a government tax credit for kids, we're going to force inoculations on you. Oh, you're on Social Security disability for physical or mental, Maybe you've got narcolepsy. Can't have guns. So that's where this is going. Very, very serious. That's in the next segment. Finishing up, Anthony Gucciardi, Prostagard is really an amazing formula, and people are freaking out over it. It's like Knockout. It has everything in it known to help the prostate, and that's why it's so popular. And on top of it, it's at a low price.
Right. And, you know, you talk about salt palmetto, which is super powerful and super important. And even the Mayo Clinic has great things to say about it. Even the U.S. government has great things to say about it. But as always with these products, we're looking beyond that because that's been a staple for a long time. But then we look at things like lycopene or plant sterols, and those are on the forefront of the new salt palmetto. So as always, kind of like with Knockout, we're looking at, sure, here's the staple traditional use of a super powerful herb or a compound or whatever. But we're looking 10 years in the future. What's going to be the next salt palmetto? And that is, of course, lycopene or the plant sterols. So we're going to put those in there now. And then in 10 years, this is going to be the foundation for the additional, you know, formulations that others are doing. This is what has been the thread over and over again. I mean, look at the nascent iodine. How many nascent iodine products are out there now? Even if you just Google nascent iodine, it used to be barren. We used to just dominate it. Now, how many competitors are out there trying to imitate it? Right? They're not going to be able to imitate it, but how many are out there trying to imitate these things? That's why it's always important to be on the cutting edge and looking at the research on PubMed, the National Library of Medicine, National Library of Congress Medicine, because you need to know what is going to be the big thing in 5 to 10 years.
Because most supplement manufacturers are lazy. They're not into it. They're not trying to put out something cutting edge. They're just marketers who hire some really sexy models and really glitzy TV advertising. That's why all the real big supplement folks, I don't want to call them foodies, people that love good food are called foodies. What do you call supplement folks? Smart people. The facilities we use, the three big labs we use love us because we'll actually put together a high-quality product and actually pay for it. So they appreciate that. But it's really simple. If all these things are good, if they all work together, why not put them all in one pill? Now, some of it's cutting edge like Knockout or Prostagard. In the case of X2, we just went and got a deep earth source of iodine, so it's the strongest, purest out there, and it has a better effect, and it's not in the alcohol that seems to bind with iodine, and we believe from our research make it not nascent or not atomically charged to go through all the science where it's able to be absorbed by the body. I mean, we made iodine popular. Nobody else was pushing this. Now, as you said, there's all these competitors who are even mad at us because they're too lazy to go figure out how to get deep earth crystals. I mean, I'm sure they could do it. And they're too lazy to not stick it in, you know, other things like alcohol that ruin it. I mean, look, I was taking iodine. It was giving me stomach aches. It was giving me more energy. I was losing weight. So I went out and developed with a group in a palm oil organic base where it's injected in a patented system with Russian technology as a gas. And it doesn't hurt my stomach. And it turns bright blue on paper because that's the color of iodine crystals is electric purple, not red. And again, I don't want to get into it all. We've had chemists look at it. Something weird is happening when iodine, especially from an ocean source, is added into alcohol. It just turns it into grunge.
You know, I would equate it to, we have these three manufacturers, right? And we're always, I would equate them to being Albert Einstein, okay, as an example. And most people are going up to Albert Einstein saying, what's 3 plus 3? What's 3 plus 3? That's the other people making their supplements, right?
Or what's the cheapest?
Yeah, what's the cheapest thing? Spending 10 cents. But I'm saying we're giving him these algorithms and we're making him solve them. These chemists are so excited about us because we're so interesting. We're always pushing the bar. You know, we're always spending the money on the research. They're excited about it. As opposed to these other companies, many new companies also, by the way, popping up, you know, spamming everybody with ads and stuff like that. And they just take the 10 cent bottle stuff that I see all the time. And I see.
Well, I mean, exactly. But beyond that, most big manufacturers, they only want one or two ingredients because then they never have a supply chain problem.
That too.
We put, you know, 10 things in each product or more. And we cold press the Super Male, Super Female Vitality, much more expensive. We use the raw, fresh herbs because we really want to be the best. And it does cause supply problems, but it doesn't matter. We're still the best. And our market share is growing. Free market ideas. It's funding the InfoWar. It's beautiful. InfoWarsLife.com to secure yours. Thank you, Anthony. Thank you for joining us, ladies and gentlemen. I am your host, Alex Jones. We've got about 26 minutes left in this worldwide transmission. I'll be back, obviously, tomorrow live. I intend to take a bunch of phone calls. There's some special guests lined up this week. There's also InfoWars Nightly News, 7 o'clock Central, Monday through Friday, with a lot of high-powered breaking news, condensed reports, special guests, the analysis and breakdown of our reporters, all teleprompter free. And that's the key. Teleprompter free. Some of the news up on InfoWars.com. This is actually in the New York Magazine. Feminist, not allowing your wife to sleep with other men is sexist, but it's not good for you to do it. The dad stays home and takes care of the kids while mom goes out and has two sexual partners a week. I'm not kidding. She'll tell me about how she had sex with Paulo. And I'm glad because I'm a feminist. No, what you are is a dominated idiot, and statistically your marriage will end and your kids will end up completely unhappy. But that's the type of news up on InfoWars.com. It's all designed to make us dumb, dependent, worldly, stupid, easily controllable morons who have no values, so will stand for nothing. This is scientifically focused. It's over the top. Now, it was last Friday that I saw an article in the Daily Caller linked up at drudgereport.com, and I knew this was coming, but there it was. Obama has promised upwards of 20 initiatives that he didn't announce. He just said, we've got as many as 20 initiatives earlier this year that he would start announcing later this year. Well, it's now later this year. Gun import bans, restrictions on bullets, supporting groups suing gun manufacturers, trying to put local databases through the NICS system, and then designating people unable to own guns who are not restricted under the 68 Gun Control Act. It says if you've been declared mentally incompetent or are a felon or have a restraining order against you for domestic violence, that you can't own or buy a gun at that time. And they have selectively enforced this. They have misapplied it. The Brady bill got struck down because of it at the Supreme Court. The problem is that we know the model is the VA. And the VA, for now about 16, 17 years, since the end of the Clinton administration, through Bush, now really bad under Obama, it's intensified, have put over 1 million veterans on a no-buy list. And most of the time, it's because they collapsed and had a heat stroke, and then they call it PTSD, or they've had arms or legs blown off, or they have a brain injury and have a speech impediment. Well, that's exactly who needs to have a gun, is somebody with no criminal record who got an arm or a leg blown off and who has a side of their face blown off. So they can't be preyed upon by predators. I mean, it's handicapped folks. Oh, I use a politically incorrect term, but it's okay to disarm them. Just say disabled. See how they replace rights with just a bunch of faux papering over to get you diverted? You know, abort all the black babies. 52% of blacks are aborted, but, you know, ban the rebel flag. It has nothing to do with slavery. This is the mind control. And sure enough, here's the article. Obama pushes to end gun background checks. Obama pushes to extend, I had a Freudian slip, Obama pushes to extend gun background checks to Social Security. And it goes on to say there's no simple way to identify that group, but a strategy used by the Department of Veterans Affairs since the creation of the background check system is reporting anyone who's been declared incompetent to manage their pension or disability payments and assigned a fiduciary. Boom. So you have a fiduciary, might be your lawyer, might be your banker you trust, might be your dad, your mom, your mother, your father, your son, your daughter. And so you got your arm blown off, your leg blown off, you've got an injury. It's not mental now. See, and we knew this. They're just coming in, and I mean, I know lots of veterans. I know a famous football player that was a UT football player, then an NFL football player. He didn't want me to say his name on air. But I met him at a birthday party a few years ago, and I looked him up. I'm not a huge football follower, but I even knew who he was. And he's a grandfather now, no criminal record. But in Vietnam, he was at UT, got out of UT, went to Vietnam for two tours, and then went and joined the NFL. He's pretty famous. But the point is, he went to buy his 10-year-old grandson a 22 rifle, hadn't bought a gun in a long time. He already had guns. And they said, sorry, you can't buy that. You've been put on a list. And he went back and couldn't find out exactly, but he'd had heat stroke in Vietnam and had been in the hospital for a week from it. Heat exhaustion. And they just said, well, that could have been PTSD. So just, it's probably that you can't buy guns anymore, and we might actually come take them from you. Well, now the coming and taking is going to begin. So here's the headline from Patrick Howley, investigative reporter on the political beat for dailycaller.com. ATF works with FBI and VA to get veterans' guns taken away. And he joins us to break this down. I saw the Daily Caller reporting on it last week. They're reporting on it more, finding details today. But this is no judge, no jury, no nothing. A lot of folks are in a car wreck. They'll tell you, oh, go to a psychologist. And they'll say, you know, I think you have PTSD. We're going to pay for these psychology meetings. Or if you get in a divorce, generally it's the woman's side. They'll get up and say, we like to call for family evaluation and for counseling for the children and both parents. And the court loves that because it's tens of thousands of dollars a year for both parties. And then it signs on. And then you're in the system there. And it's like, you know, how about we just say, I see this in the news all the time. Let's just say you have PTSD from this divorce. How'd you like to get all this paid for on your insurance? Boom, your guns are gone. So they get everybody trapped first on the system, not telling you, then this happens. So this is the biggest strike, the biggest attack on the Second Amendment I've ever seen. And it's being done just as a no big deal routine, kind of like Planned Parenthood, new videos out with their national director of their council. That's like their vice chairman. This female doctor is on tape going, yeah, I want to buy a Lamborghini. And, you know, we want the lowest price on these body parts for the organ harvesting. And she just matter of fact calling it the supplies. We need the supplies. Can you get us the supplies? Can you get us the product? It's the same thing here. Yeah, we got to get these bitter clangers. We're not going to stop the illegal aliens having guns or criminals or open borders. You know, we're just going to go. We've been going after the veterans. Now it's going to be the old people so they can be preyed upon. So joining us is Patrick Howley. Patrick, I tell you, this is bold. This is bold. And, of course, they're going to camel's nose under the tent flap like they did with Clinton and the vets. But this is intensifying. The vets just complain. Yeah, suddenly I can't buy guns. Then you get in New York, California, and Illinois, where they're more bold, they have these state federally funded task forces. They come and say, hey, we don't need any trouble. We're just taking your guns. We're taking you in for psychological evaluation. Don't give us trouble or we're going to have to arrest you. Your medical records show that you were given a designation 20 years ago, 10 years ago, 5 years ago. And it's not that you even are mentally ill or considered violent. It's that you just had some type of psychological counseling. I mean, this is so draconian. You've really ferreted into this. You've really dug into this. What can you tell us?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me, and thanks for highlighting this issue, because a lot of publications wouldn't. The Los Angeles Times picked it up just recently, but a few weeks ago, essentially, I started this off by obtaining a memo through a source from inside the Federal Bureau of Investigation showing that the FBI... and they broke this down. Every month, the Department of Veterans Affairs sends a CD-ROM disc with the names, new names each month of veterans who they feel should be on the National Instant Criminal Background Check list. Now, these are people who did not commit crimes. These are not criminals. These are not people who should be on the National Instant Criminal Background Check system. But these are people who the VA has determined through their own counseling services and their own VA health services. So if these veterans actually do manage to get off the secret paper waiting lists and get in to the facilities to get a real doctor's appointment, they just might say something or do something that will set off the VA. The VA will put them on the list. The FBI does not review these cases. The FBI does not investigate these cases. The FBI merely takes this CD-ROM disc from the VA and immediately puts these people on the National Instant Criminal Background Check system, and it's up to the VA. So we know that the FBI and the VA are working together on this. Hundreds of thousands of veterans have been put on the National Instant Criminal Background Check system without their knowledge. for things such as, you know, switching their bank account to auto pay or debit card. They don't want to cash a paycheck because nobody does anymore. So they just have the their pension and benefits put directly onto their debit card. So that is enough to get you onto the list. Having a nurse in your house to cook for household chores if you're old or injured, that's enough to get you on the list. As far as I'm concerned, that those are the kind of people who need guns because, you know, if somebody breaks into their house. But that's enough to get you onto the list.
Let me just stop you. This is incredible. You have the FBI memo. You've linked to it in your articles. You broke this story. I think it's important to point that out. I said the Daily Caller did. You did. Great job. They're trying to get rid of investigative journalists that actually dig into the meat here. So my interpretation watching this since Clinton's time is dead on to what the memo says. They just use anything. The fact that a nurse comes and sees you twice a week, the fact that you've got enough money to have a lady that comes and cooks for you some, or a maid, a helper. I mean, that's what we all hope we can have when we're old. This is just wild to say you're incompetent, you shouldn't have a gun, and they've got a bunch of politically motivated socialists and others in there tasked with doing this. No judge, no jury, no nothing. You just can't get a gun. And now the new phase is they're coming to take the guns. I mean, this is the gun confiscation of the veterans, and now it's going to be the Social Security crowd. But don't think that the AARP is going to say a word. Please continue.
The AARP is definitely on board with the Obama agenda 100%. I mean, they're one of his biggest supporters. The funny thing is, and it's not funny, but I use that term in a dark way, is that a lot of these things, like having a nurse or switching your payments to debit or all these trivial things that get people on the list, were suggested to the veterans by the VA. I've talked to veterans who said, I didn't need a nurse to come by. The VA said, you do need a nurse. We've decided that you need a nurse. We're going to give you one. The veteran says, okay, and then the VA puts them down on the list. Now they have a nurse. So it's the VA actually driving these numbers. But, you know, now, as we know, my source has come back with even more documents and found that ATF is now involved. ATF is now working behind the scenes with the FBI on enforcing these cases. ATF, I mean, your viewers know ATF very well. This is the enforcement arm. So we know that the FBI and the VA has been putting these people on the list. Now that they're on the list, ATF knows about it, and ATF can come and knock on your door, and they're going to have guns when they come.
So they're clearly, from your research, correct me if I'm wrong, I've read your series of articles, they're gearing up is what you're saying. This is a major offensive.
Oh, absolutely, and especially the fact that they're going after the Social Security Administration now. Every single person in this country who gets Social Security benefits, which is basically everyone I know over a certain age is in the Social Security system. Anything you say related to the Social Security Administration, anything you put down on your medical records, that can now be used against you to send ATF agents to your house to take away your guns. And President Obama, who's in the last days of his presidency, and who has a media who doesn't report on this kind of thing, it's just going to start enforcing this. And what can people do? They can write to you, Alex, or they can write to me, or they can write to another journalist and said, hey, I had an ATF agent come to my house. But that's not going to be page one in the New York Times. Obama's not going to see any political consequences for this. But the crackdown is starting now.
That's right. The crackdown on Social Security recipients having their guns taken is accelerating. I remember the headline 2 years ago in Bloomberg, gun confiscation begins in California. That's not an Infowars.com headline or a DailyCaller.com headline or something on DrudgeReport.com. That is their words to condition people, and it's like veterans that can't take care of themselves or who are mentally ill. And then you find out it's, in some of the cases I've seen, it'll be like a 25-year-old vet that has both his legs blown off. And they go, you know, you're too depressed to have a 45, 9/11. 1911. Well, that's exactly who needs to have a gun. I mean, I'm 41, and I've gotten to the point where if some thug tries to attack me, I've got a gun in my car, I'm just going to shoot him. I'm not going to fight him. When I was 18, I might have just fought him. I could probably still beat him, but I'm not going to give him that chance if they're assaulting me with my children. I've got a job to stay alive. Well, imagine if I had an arm and a leg blown off, or both legs blown off, or was paralyzed chest down. Those people need to be protected. This is outrageous, preying on old people and veterans. It's just despicable.
Oh, of course it is. And it reflects tremendous contempt on the part of the progressive establishment, the progressive elite. And let's be clear, they are the elite. When it comes to veterans, when it comes to people who have served this country, when it comes to what they perceive as the radical right or disenfranchised right-wing white men, you know, they're not doing anything about the cartels coming over the border. There are fast and furious guns being left at crime scenes here in the United States. You know, but if one of those people with a Fast and the Furious Eric Holder gun comes in and tries to rob you, and you're a 68-year-old with no knees because they got blown off in Vietnam, maybe you're going to end up on this list and you're not going to be able to have a firearm to protect yourself.
I can't tell you how many phone calls I've gotten on air, how many letters. I'll start sending them to you or give them to my reporters. And how many people I've met in person that go, you're telling the truth. I went in and I can't get a gun now and I have no criminal record, but I'm a veteran. They told me it's something in my record. I can't tell you how many people in Texas, because of all these Californians moving in mainly, not knocking Californians, but the people that are socialists. And if they hear you shooting on your 200-acre ranch, they call the police on you. And the police go, well, they feel threatened. We're taking your guns. So they just roll out this red carpet to anti-gunners everywhere. So outside of law, outside, they're just taking the guns. I mean, this is a real line in the sand that they're crossing. We need congressional investigations. We need the VA defunded. They're already denying health care to the vets. They're already putting them on no, don't treat death list. I mean, the VA is a useless organization. And now it's the Social Security Administration is going to take this system and the policies and take 65 and up people's guns. They want the guns from the good people. I think it's dawning on the public. In fact, I know it is, that true criminal evil is taking over. And they got some really bad things planned. It's why they want to wage war on gun owners, veterans, and now they're going to harass with their social workers, with their bureaucrats, backed up by the ATF, the folks barbecuing little kids at Waco, coming after our guns. I want to get Patrick Howley, investigative journalist from dailycaller.com, on routinely. And really beat the drum until this becomes a national story. LA Times picked it up 2 weeks after he started reporting it. I didn't know about it until a week ago. So it just shows how we need to get these stories out to people. I didn't know about this for a week. I guess I read his third or fourth article and posted it on Infowars.com. We need to get aggressive because it's on. They are coming for the guns. Not of criminals. They're coming for people 65 and up. Sir, other points need to be made here. There's going to be more shoes to drop. What else are you investigating right now?
Well, I mean, I just think it's so interesting, as you reported on earlier in the show, how we see these armed civilians now taking it upon themselves to go to these recruitment centers in response to these jihadi threats. And, you know, defend these recruitment centers because they know that the feds are not going to do it. So I think it's very interesting right now that we see veterans being targeted for being disarmed. We see older people, patriotic people, you know, so-called right-wing people who are being disarmed. Just as we have this situation where jihadis are coming over and shooting people, shooting Marines, and forcing citizens to go to these recruitment centers and stand guard. And take it upon themselves and do their patriotic duty to stand guard. And so I think the timing right now is very interesting. I think the timing, is especially when you have White House-supported riots in Baltimore and in Ferguson, Missouri, and other places around the country, that only a certain kind of people are being targeted for being disarmed. The Reason magazine comment section on Reason.com was the subject of a Department of Justice inquiry where they were trying to find out the names of the commenters, but they're not trying to find out who the cartels are that are running over the border. They're not trying to find out who is burning down the buildings in Ferguson. You know, so it's selective prosecution. And as we become more and more, as they stoke the flames of this division, and bring us closer and closer to a violent point, God forbid a violent point, they are doing everything they can to disarm the people who they think are going to be on the other side.
Absolutely. I mean, it looks like they're trying to run the Ayers playbook or the Saul Alinsky playbook. And I'd always hear that about Obama 8 years ago when he was running. And I was like, come on, it's not that bad. I mean, I didn't like Obama, obviously, but McCain was horrible, too. Now we really see they really mean it. These are like weirdo 60s communist radicals with nuclear weapons, and they're crazy. I mean, I remember the famous story. If you can do five more minutes, stay with us. If you've got to go, I understand we got a one-minute break. But the famous first inauguration of the Clintons, Ron Silver, the now-deceased Hollywood producer and star, was, how dare those F-16s fly over? So ignorant, so weird. You know, they're threatening us. And Hillary Clinton goes, Silver, those are our planes now. That shows how disconnected. But it is. They've dominated. They've taken over. They run the country. They've got the big punch bowl all to themselves. And they just can't help but use it as a porta potty. I mean, I hate to use that allegory, but I mean, these people really are mentally ill radicals who want to start a civil war. They are criminals. They are enemies. They are treacherous. They are seditious. They are insane. They are mentally ill. They sell body parts of children. They're ghouls. I mean, they're villains. We'll be back in 60 seconds, 70 seconds. I myself have gotten too comfortable with the tyranny by successive approximation, by incrementalism, to where I was just sitting here this weekend going, I'm not even this upset that they're going to start confiscating. It's well over a million vets since Clinton that have had their guns taken, most of the time for no reason. And then I saw the LA Times reporting on it like it was good. They're not even hiding it. And then I realized I've got to make a big deal out of this week. That's what we're fighting against, is the normalization of the bottom dropping out and just living under total tyranny. I've been ranting, Patrick Howley. You've got the floor for the last 4 minutes to go over other points you'd like to make about this and other things you've got on your radar screen with their anti-gun push.
You know, this is something that has been in the works for a long time. One of President Obama's major political disappointments was how the Senate blocked his background checks bill when it came up through in a filibuster. Ted Cruz, thankfully, was able to save that from going through. And so he was very unhappy. He had the Newtown families out there and saying, this is a shameful day for the Senate. So now that he's in his legacy building mode, he is really focusing on disarmament and getting guns away from the kinds of people that he doesn't want to have guns. And, you know, The gangbangers in inner cities, they have guns, okay? Cartels coming across the border have guns. Lots of people who are in the Progressive Coalition have guns. But why is it that veterans, and why is it that a certain kind of older, more conservative-leaning person is now being targeted? You know, I think that what you said earlier about the fact that they always thought that a civil war was going to occur in this country, or that the Civil War is still going on. I think that comes straight off the 60s college campuses. I think Obama's trained in that. I think Hillary Clinton certainly is trained on that, personal friend of Saul Alinsky. And I think that as long as the progressive movement is still able to get all this money from Europe and from George Soros and from these big-time socialist billionaires to keep their supremacy going, the heated-up, ridiculous nonsense rhetoric, violent, divisive rhetoric, of 60s college campuses is going to continue to dominate the political conversation in this country. And they'll use CNN, they'll use the media, they'll use the New York Times and their media apparatus to get their points out and to put that propaganda out there. But the fever dreams of their 60s radical student days live on now in public policy. And I think that's a very scary thing.
I just keep thinking there's got to be some end to it. It gets more bizarre, more weird, more crazy by the minute. I go back to the example of Ron Silver saying, how dare them threaten us with jets? You know, it's the military. That's how anti-American they are. And then Hillary's like, no, those are our jets now. I mean, they've dominated and taken over and already wrecked things so bad. What do they think's going to happen when they push people all the way to the wall? They're going to have a civil war and then put libertarians and conservatives in internment camps, fun camps that Hillary talked about and Wesley Clark talked about. I mean, they really are villains, but they're so weak and pathetic. Don't they know once they push things into real revolution, they're going to get their butts kicked?
Well, they're certainly trying to stamp out the ideology. You know, I have a sister who's 16, and ask her about any political issue based on her schooling and public education. Or private education on college campuses, and she will recite the most left-wing propaganda I've ever heard in my entire life. They're brainwashing these children. They are stamping out the ideology that they don't like, they think that they can get the young people to march in lockstep with the progressive movement, and there aren't going to be any young libertarians or young right wingers, cropping up in the future. And so the ones who already exist need to be taken care of. I don't think it's going to come to internment camps, but what's the difference when you have ATF knocking down your door and putting a gun in your face and saying, give us your guns because, you have a nurse and so therefore you're on the criminal background check.
Sure, it's the same thing. I mean, it's like Seinfeld's a big liberal and he said, I said, hey, you have a boyfriend? And she goes, that's sexist. I mean, it's a cult. They really are a cult. By every sense, thank you so much, Patrick Howley, Daily Caller. Thank you so much. Your reports are key. Folks, get them out and get the video of this interview out to